Hello! Oh my, I've never hit the
Very
red.
loud.
Hold on. It's probably coming in from different.
Hello! Alright. Sorry, everybody. Blew your ear holes out. Welcome back. Welcome to Sundays with COD. I am Reborn. This is.
Blue Boy. Hello.
Hello. We're gonna finish up this story with about a hooker tonight. About 45 minutes of audio. The audio is coming from inside of Warren's trailer. Sorry, guys. Computer is a pile of shit. Do you want to recap what happened last call?
So Lauren had a hooker come visit the
Yes.
trailer, and she took a look around. She did not like what she saw, and Lauren got upset about that. And I think that's where we left off. Did he? I don't know how it ended.
Yeah, that's pretty much where it was. He hangs up. I think Jamie said something about like fuck off or something.
Oh yeah, she hung up on him.
Yeah. Oh, we got a donation from Love that says, "Can you please tell Will and Rod thank you for the wonderful job messing with Lauren Armstrong, Lame Armstrong?" Thank you, Love.
We'll let him know.
We'll let him know.
What else happened?
She showed up. Well, the first part of it was him saying they were going to move in.
Okay.
Then she showed up and he was pissed because she walked around like she owned the place.
Oh, right. She looked at the chicken house.
The chicken house, the chicken shack, the chicken house, the chicken shed, the chicken pen. I think there's another one. So now he calls back to Jamie and Jamie's going to pick up.
It's not, first of all,
Yeah.
size of a beetle bug. It not only is it not hooker suitable, it's not even good enough for a homeless hooker.
That's right. She was living in her truck, but she was perfect for Will. That was another
She's
thing.
perfect for that. Yeah, you missed last week. She's
Yeah.
perfect for Will.
She's perfect for Will. All right. You know what? She's probably really off today here, guys. Sorry, hold on. Oh, if my computer will allow me to do this.
She asked if she could stay in the chicken house, right?
She went over and was like, "What's this?"
Guy
Is
living
what
there?
Lauren says. Yeah. "Hey, what's this over here?" "It's a fucking chicken house."
You dumb bitch.
All right. Let's get into this and hear what he's got to say.
What?
What? Why are you telling me to fuck off?
It's a great. I mean, why not?
You called
I tried to
me.
help.
Why wouldn't I say what?
Well, why would you tell me to fuck off? I tried to do something nice and help somebody, and you're telling me
Because
to
I
fuck
want you
off.
to.
Really?
Really?
And that's how you feel about me.
Sorry,
Right
Zach.
now, yeah.
And why is that? Because I try to help somebody out and they act like a fucking idiot? Or is it because it's my job to look after Roy when Roy can't look after himself?
Because you are angry, a woman rejected you and you are throwing a tantrum.
Got him.
No. I'm pissed about the way she acted. I tried to fucking help her, and the way she acted is what pissed me off.
How did she act?
She acted like she owned the place.
I don't know what she even did.
She walked up and said, "I'm not living in that."
That's it?
Yeah, that's it. How dare she? Oh, and then he had a problem with her clothes. Remember that?
Oh, yeah, she's
she was
wearing
wearing
slutty clothes.
She's wearing a halter top and a mini skirt with heels on.
God damn it.
What a whore.
These young girls nowadays, man.
Yeah. I gotta show you what she looks like. I made her today. You gotta see it. It's pretty good. But yeah, that's it. Didn't want to live in a shipping container in Lauren's fucking yard. That's about it. They're loving the Sika stuff.
Oh,
whatever
thank
that
you.
means.
The Sika stuff's fun. I enjoy it. She's pretty crazy.
She's a nut job. I don't know. I don't know who we're talking about.
Well, it applies to both, I guess. This hooker and Sika, they're both crazy.
Despite her saying no, is what pissed you off?
No, the way she acted is what pissed me off.
I sound
What pissed me off is when she fucking left and was leaving and just walked right through her truck and said, nice truck, that's been following me around for days.
I'm not on headphones.
I said, what? I've never even fucking seen you.
Alright, hold on, let me.
I think it's my AirPods make me sound weird sometimes.
Your AirPods, yeah, that can do it. AirPods are kind of jank sometimes. I'm gonna go back and play that because he was pissy about, basically what we were
What pissed me off
about.
Is when she fucking left and fucking was leaving and just walked right through her truck and said, nice truck, that's been following me around for days. I said, why? I've never even fucking seen you.
But he had. Saw her at the hotel.
That's what pissed me off.
Yeah, he did. He went and saw her earlier.
That's the biggest thing that pissed me off.
Yeah. Have I heard any news why Lauren's trailer isn't... Trailer's for sale. I don't have news, but I could take a wild guess. He wasn't going to sell the fucking thing.
That, yeah, I'm sure they were tired of people calling in.
Yeah.
Asking the same questions we all asked. Like, so, is a pedophile living there?
Yeah, like 15 people calling asking the same. You know Lauren lives there, right?
I wonder if they took it down and they're going to relist it for, like, a reasonable price. You think, maybe? Or do you think Lauren just gave up?
I think Lauren gave up. I think if it didn't work the first time, he usually goes on to the next scheme.
Yeah.
You know? My guess, at least.
I don't understand how he thought that was ever going to work.
I don't know.
Was it, 'cause if the idea is to, like, escape people knowing where he is, well, we're going to know where he is anyways.
I think it was more about the money. So, he was under the impression that people on YouTube made, you know, hundreds and thousands of dollars, right? Oh, shit. I closed the wrestling. What happened? Hold on, guys. But he thinks people are making tons of money, right? So he thinks that someone in this community is dumb enough to just drop $70,000 to get the land so they can say they owned it, is my guess. Because he really thought someone could pay that and then realized, like, it's stupid.
Who knows? It would have been great to ask him, but...
It's either that or he thought he was going to get people's information when they applied to look for the place so he could get names for these arrests that are coming in under 84 days.
Yeah, we're like under the... We're getting pretty close here. 84 days.
It's under 100. We're nearing the end times.
So everyone, I mean, start changing your names now because we're all going on the lam.
Yeah. Batter, pick your bunkies now because... All right. Let's see what he says next.
No, hooking myself up with around to be around people like that.
Seems like a sensitive issue for you.
Damn straight it is. I'm not being around people like that. I don't want people like that in my life.
Have you been called a stalker before?
Not that I ever remember. I've never stalked anybody.
You had to think about that for a second.
I don't want to talk about that.
If you've ever
I've never
that question,
even fucking seen her before today.
Like immediately.
Right, someone was like, hey, have you ever, has anyone called you a stalker before? No.
Let me think.
Not that I'm aware of.
Yeah, what kind of answer is that? Not that I'm aware of.
Right. Right.
The answer should be no. Immediately no.
Immediately no. Eel, we'll get to that. Trust me. It's mentioned.
What?
Nikki says otherwise.
Oh.
Jim brings up Nikki, I believe.
Not that you know of.
No, that I ever remember. I don't ever remember seeing her. I've never met her. I don't ever even remember seeing her truck.
Omega, I will make sure that Blue Boy and I are there to preach the good word in our cell block, okay? Mm-hmm. We'll find a way.
My one concentration has been on you. I don't stalk people.
He doesn't stalk people.
What a weird, like, compliment. Was that supposed to be a compliment? Like, I only stalk you, Jamie.
Listen, the only person I'm stalking is you.
I have no time to stalk prostitutes. All my concentration is on you.
Yeah. I'm worried about every move you make. I don't have time for a prostitute.
So you've never been called a stalker?
Not that I know of. I've never intentionally stalked anybody.
Not that you know of.
Intentionally?
No. Not that I know of.
This is like...
I've never intentionally stalked anybody. And then I like
Have you accidentally stalked anyone before?
I don't know how you could accidentally stalk someone. And then he threw this in.
No. Not that I know of.
Not that I know of.
Don't add that in there. You would know if you're stalking somebody.
What does that mean? Yeah, not that I know of. I don't recall stalking them. I unintentionally stalk. That's your main name.
There, sometimes I'll be driving behind someone and I realize I've been following them for several miles. I guess that's unintentional stalking, maybe.
I guess. I feel like if it's stalking, you'd have to follow it through until they parked.
Oh, like we're both going to the same place.
Yeah, like you park it right behind me. Like, listen, I'm just here to get Red Robin or something.
Red Robin. You throw that out there.
Is like super low overall. Is there a way to make you louder?
Yeah, you can turn your headphones up.
Oh!
Oh, got her.
Here, hold on. That's as high as it can go. It's just this mic, really. I think I even have like a filter on it to boost it. Here. If I put any more gain on this, it's gonna probably start distorting it, but I'll raise it a little more.
Well, make them louder, Jill Pill. Okay?
Aw, baby boy, do you like my new name? Now I can get a shout out whenever Lauren's. Yeah, that's a great name. I don't know.
Aw, baby boy.
I don't know what your name was before baby boy, but it's one of my favorite things. Yeah, no problem, Jill Pill. All right, let's see what he follows up with. Uncle Clay's coming, right? Let's see what he follows this up unintentional stalking with.
Why the fuck would she say that when I just met her today? I don't ever even remember seeing her ever before. I don't
even
go to bars. I don't fucking hang around people like that. I don't drink.
Did your charge ever come up? Is that why her attitude changed?
My charge never came up.
So you've never been called a stalker?
How many times are you going to ask me the same question?
Because I know the answer.
Well, what's the answer? Who's called me a stalker before?
You tell me.
Jimmy, I'm not playing that goddamn game.
He knows.
This girl said that shit and that pissed me off. I've never even fucking seen her before.
Yeah.
Have you ever had a restraining order?
Nope.
Another lie.
He answered that one quickly.
Nope.
There was Nikki. I think it was Nikki. I didn't. There was no restraining order. Just
he fucking knew it.
Just
instantly.
A cop came and wanted me to fucking leave Nikki alone.
That doesn't happen to just regular people.
Cops just don't show up at your house and say,
"Hey,
stop
leave
that.
Her alone."
Yeah, hey, stop talking to this woman. I'm gonna back you up so you guys can hear that again.
There was Nikki. I think it was Nikki. I didn't. There was no restraining order. Just a cop came and wanted me to fucking leave Nikki alone. It's like I never even fucking did anything to Nikki, but try to help her.
Oh, kind of like this.
Nikki
hooker.
Was the one that screwed me over big time with money when I was trying to fucking help her.
Well, that popped up real quick, mister. You don't think so?
No, I just remembered, okay? I try to leave out the bad parts of my life because I don't want to remember them. I forget.
I'm just trying to give her a place to stay. I'm just helping her out. It's not stalking.
Forget about them. Then they pop in my head and I wind up remembering.
Right.
All right. Why is it you're trying to put me down? Yeah, convenient. Convenient that you want to put me down for fucking trying to help somebody else. Don't you find something wrong with that?
You don't
convenient how I don't want to fucking help Roy when he don't want to help himself. Because I don't want him getting my ass in trouble. But yet you still think that it's wrong that
but
I should still help
him
out.
You don't want to help him. No.
But I should still take the chance to try to help Roy so he can get my ass in trouble. So you don't mind if Roy, if I help Roy out and he comes here and drinks and gets me in trouble.
The lady
you don't mind
you off now, you don't want to help him.
I was like, if you guys remember from last week, holy shit, Roy, I forgot his name for a second. Roy was gonna stay there, but the second this prostitute didn't want to stay there, now all of a sudden it's a problem.
Everyone's out.
Now Roy can't stay there because he's hanging out with people like that, and he doesn't want to get, and Lauren doesn't want to get in trouble. But it was cool when she was gonna stay there.
Right. When the young woman in a miniskirt was gonna stay there, Roy's alcohol wasn't an issue.
Yeah.
But now that she's not staying there, Roy's gotta go.
Thanks. And gets me in trouble.
The lady
you don't mind
you off now, you don't want to help him. Think you keep ignoring that part.
No, that's seeing what he's bringing around him. Because he's not gonna bring stuff around me like that.
Right.
Right, right. It's obvious you don't care if I get in trouble.
Oh my god. So, I teased this last week. This is where the turn happens, and now it's going to be Lorne bitching that she's not protecting him from Roy, even though he's the one that said, I'm going to have Roy move in.
Yeah.
So, get ready for this, because it's going to get frustrating.
Just as long as I try to help Roy out. When I've tried to fucking help Roy out, and he doesn't care.
Prove that point, thanks.
Yeah, just prove what point? That I'm not gonna get my ass in trouble to fucking help him because he can't help himself?
You didn't care until today.
He's a grown man.
You didn't care until today.
I didn't see until today.
The lady pissed you off, now you don't want to help him. Think you keep ignoring that part.
No, I want to help him, but
you
he doesn't want to help himself. Don't fucking keep repeating yourself and trying to fucking blame it all on me because he's a goddamn alcoholic and don't want to help himself. Isn't it funny how you don't want to look out for me?
You just proved that point, thanks.
You just proved that you don't want to fucking look out for me. Thanks.
How would she look out for him?
Because what he wants is like, you shouldn't have Roy there, you're going to get in trouble and go to prison, we'll never be together, oh no.
Shut up.
No.
Hang up.
Fuck you.
Ooh.
Oh.
Fuck off.
Oh, baby boy.
Damn.
Baby boy. He's a little upset. Again, I don't understand this whole, like, Roy's gonna move in, and then it's, why aren't you protecting me from Roy? Mike Scott, I think that if she were to have moved in, Lauren would, like, find reasons to go bug her all the time in the shed. In the metal shed.
Yeah, I mean, was she, I forgot if you mentioned it, was she allowed to use the bathroom and shower in the trailer?
Well, I'm gonna say yes, just based on Lauren's personality.
Yeah,
but
did he ever say it though?
No, it was like, what are they gonna do for showers and stuff? And he was like, well, Uncle Clay's gonna run a pipe when I get gravel.
Oh, right.
And there was no real like straight answer to that. I got a donation from Jill Pill. She says he was going to help this hookah and Roy by taking their $400 a month, taking their free labor and still using the container they would be living in, and Jamie's acting like he was all in it for himself, smart ass. Just stroke there at the end. Thank you, Jill. Pill. Yeah. It was a pretty lopsided deal, in my opinion. I mean, you get half of a shipping container, you have to pay $400.
Oh, that's right. You don't even get the whole shipping container.
No, he gets half for his tools and his other wares and trinkets.
He gets up early to go do stuff outside too.
Oh yeah,
so
he's up
you're not
here.
Getting a moment's peace and quiet.
3 a.m. He's just like fake hammering shit,
yeah,
to wake him up. Oh, sorry, are you dressed in here?
He's going in there whenever he wants to take.
Just asking for whatever. Oh, also, I don't. Love also donated again. Said face to face. Appreciate that,
face
love.
To face.
And Jill Pill, thank you. A Lauren side deal, definitely, definitely. We know for a fact that she was a hooker. Teardown Mouse, we do not. I'm just guessing based on the fact that she was homeless and then she was like cuddling up to Roy. And I believe Roy one time said she was locked in the bathroom for a while. I would assume
she was a young woman who hung out with Roy in a motel room.
Yeah.
After, I mean, infer what you want from that.
Yeah, fair enough. Okay, let's maybe not call it...
I'm going to call her a hooker.
Okay, yeah, I'm just going to stick with what
it's
I'm
just
saying.
Easier.
It's easier.
Yeah, everyone knows who I'm talking about.
Yeah, instead of, you know, because I don't want to be like, the 25-year-old woman staying with Roy at the hotel. It's real wordy. Hooker, instant. Yeah. Is a violation of Lauren's probation for Roy to have liquor on the property? If not, what's the matter if Roy's drinking there?
I think it is.
Dude, he says it is, and I can't remember. I haven't looked at his probation rules in ages. I would assume so. But, again, he is... We're going to see maybe Hooker wrestle. We are. Just it might not be soon, guys, but... I just assume it is, and... If it's not, I mean, Lauren was tested for drinking, and it's very easy to just put his ass on a lie detector, and he's going to fail it.
Yeah.
So, I really don't think he has anything to worry about. I think if he went to probation, which he never would, but if he went to probation and said, listen, my brother is on hard times, he's drinking, I am not going to drink, you can give me my breathalyzer back and I'll do it.
Yeah.
It would be game over, you know?
Yeah, actually, now I think about it, did they ever say he's not allowed to have alcohol on the property?
They might have the second time when he went back to jail.
Okay, yeah.
When he went to jail for drinking. It's hard to say. I can't remember his revised rules and stuff, but was potential hooker number three ever caught on audio?
Who's potential hooker one and two?
I don't know. I'm just assuming this is the end-all be-all of hookers, but I can't remember, to be honest with you. I know that Lauren talked to her on the phone, but I don't remember if Jamie had been listening in at any point.
I don't think he was supposed to.
I know there's a time where she talked to Roy. Well, Roy was... Do you remember when Lauren called Roy when he was in the hotel? And Jamie was on the line and he goes, oh, you're on three-way, I gotta go. Like, Roy was drunk and was smarter than Lauren and just knew to hang up.
Yes, I do remember that.
So, I'm not sure. It's hard to say. Again, Lauren is the one narrating this thing and he is unreliable in his narrations, so...
Where'd you get that from?
His psych eval. So. Medium Syllables donated and said, door dogs or ham cubes?
I don't like ham, but I also don't like hot dogs either.
I like hot dogs. I do not think door dogs are acceptable anywhere.
If you're forcing me to eat one of those things...
Yeah.
That's tough. If I'm giving it a real honest answer, I'd probably go with ham cubes.
I probably would go with ham cubes as well, because at least I know what I'm getting into.
Why are those dogs in the door?
Exactly. I can't believe that came from him half asleep, just going, dog, dog. Donation from Jill Pilligan said, Lauren's terms are, the hookah gets a shower in the trailer failure, but absolutely must get dressed in the shipping container.
Oh, she has to walk nude for the...
Oh, man. Does she get a towel at
that
least?
That's the rules. Ew, can you imagine using a towel from Lauren?
Ugh. Probably has ash on
damn.
It. Just has cigarette ash
I'll
all over it.
I'll have to ask Prepperette what that feels like.
Oh my. Alright, well thank you Medium Syllables and thank you Jill Pilligan. Let's see what he says next after he hung up saying, fuck you. Actually, let's hear his hang up again because he roasted her.
Thanks.
Shut up.
No! Fuck you.
Fuck off.
Real quick, she said to shut up and he said no. Then he hung up and shut up.
But he got the last word in.
I know what a door dog is. A door dog is a hot dog in the refrigerator door, waiting for Lauren and Roy to show up and eat them, you know? Zach Donian said, they're not open tomorrow, honey. That's true. He did say that in his sleep. Good one, Zach. Yep. Thank you, Zach. Appreciate you. It's a raw dog. Yes, it's raw dog in it. Yeah, that's what a door dog is. It's just a package of hamburgers that's sitting...
Package of hot dogs.
Sorry, yes. Stroke out over here. A package of hot dogs in a door of a fridge, and you just go in and kind of like pull them out and eat them.
Oh, just uncooked?
Yeah. Yeah, and they're in there for Roy and Lauren. His mom has them in the door for them. Raw dog in it. Raw dog equals rod. Alright, guys.
What?
I want to know why you're not looking out for me.
Oh.
You want me looking out for Roy, and you want me to get my ass in
Fuck
trouble.
Off.
No. You're fucking doing this shit all...
What?
Why are you telling me to fuck off when you know when
off.
I'm telling you you're not... No, you're not looking out for...
What?
Why are you looking out for me when it comes to internet people, but when it comes to my brother wanting to get me in trouble, you're not looking out for me?
How would she look out for him, though?
Instead, it's more important that I get in trouble, so...
Wrong window. The only way I can think of it is that she says, don't let Roy live there, I don't want you to get arrested. That's the only thing it could be.
That has to be it, because, yeah, I don't...
That's the only thing. Now, I'll say this. He did say, you protect me against internet people. That is mostly just he would get a letter and read it to Jamie, and then Jamie would go, so what do you think? And
yeah.
He goes, I think it's bullshit. And go, okay.
You have to, yeah, it's when the letter writers start coming in.
Yeah.
That's protecting one from internet people.
Right, yeah. Bee's knees, thank you. I don't really know how to describe. Dog doing karate, I guess is what that is.
Oh, okay.
Appreciate it. Thank you. All right, let's see what protecting Lauren sounds like.
Instead, it's more important that I get in trouble so that he can come here and take a chance of him drinking on our property.
You were moving him into their dumb shit.
Our property.
Yeah, until I saw what he was hanging around.
Once I was okay with the hooker moving in, and then she said that she didn't like me, then it wasn't okay. Do you think Lauren's headset is deaf? Lauren's headset is deaf? I don't know.
Until I saw the way that he was acting this morning. Until this woman, because I realized that the type of girl that she is, that she doesn't give a shit about anything but her.
He was okay with the drinking when she...
Yes.
When, see, that's...
Yes, exactly.
God damn it, Lauren.
He's okay with drinking on the property as long as there's a woman in a miniskirt there. Otherwise,
yeah.
Get
well,
the fuck out of here.
It's worth it. It's worth it at that point to run the risk.
Oh, from all the yelling. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, definitely, yeah, preach.
Right, so
she doesn't give
okay
a shit
about, until this woman.
She doesn't give a shit. I had already been thinking about it this morning when I saw Roy. He doesn't care about what he's doing.
So how is this on me, dummy?
Right, but he saw her and was still on board until she showed up at the property.
What was she wearing when he first met her then?
Just
a nun
skirt.
Costume?
Just the skirt.
Okay.
No top. Yeah, yeah, she's in a nun outfit, yeah.
Yeah, because she showed up and he's like, oh, she looks like a whore. But,
right,
I mean...
She thought she was real sexy, and I think he said at one point, like, something about showing her shoulders off, something like that. I was like...
Oh, no.
All right, learned Amish man, what
yeah
the fuck are you talking about?
Lauren's very modest.
Don't show any ankle, baby.
He's old-fashioned.
You want me to look after Roy?
Fuck off.
When I finally come to the decision that I'm not going to.
Fuck off.
No! Aunt Sharon's even telling me not to let him live here.
Fuck Aunt Sharon.
No, yeah, Aunt Sharon.
Because he's going to get me in trouble. Even last weekend, he came here with alcohol. I told him, don't buy alcohol, Roy. When we stopped at Walmart, what's he do? He comes out with alcohol.
You get it? Because she's like 11 years old.
Oh,
got her again.
My. LL Fool J donated and said, just a shout out to a lost thug, Tom Cruise Heidecker Jr. Bless. He is missed. He is missed. Thank you. All right. Let's see who's going to yell about now.
And I didn't know until we got here.
About it all week. Why are you putting this on me?
Yeah.
Because you're trying to ask me why I'm not looking out for him. Why I'm giving up looking out for him. And I finally see this morning, he doesn't want to help himself. He's just there. He wasn't even drinking, but he's not even helping himself.
But
and then he brings it.
Mm-hmm.
Roy agreeing to live in the trailer, or in the shed, isn't that like a step towards helping himself?
Yeah, you would think. It's like at least a place to stay. He's not in a hotel
he's
wasting money.
You would think.
It's
not much of an upgrade, but...
It's not. I mean, I probably want to stay in the hotel. It's just, it's less... Actually, you're probably spending more money staying in that trailer. in the shed because he's making you pay $200 a month.
That's true. I gotta look up the
Wait, a month? How much?
He said $200 each a month.
Okay, then yeah, he's paying less there at the shed.
But by how much? Oh, I mean, because how much does it cost to stay at the Pinewood Motel?
I'm gonna say a crisp $5.
$5 an hour.
$5 bill. Yeah, an hour, right? Sean donated and said, "I hate how he says alcohol."
It's like how he says Donkey Kong.
Dinky King.
It's like alcohol.
There's like just letters missing.
Yeah. All the vowels.
Hooker with a penis.
Hooker with penis.
The house shed, the chicken shack.
And then he brings this girl over. That there, she sounded like she was all right. But when she got here, she acted like I owed her something.
What?
And then she said that stupid bullshit when she left. No, like, I don't want fucking people around me like that.
Days ago. Oh wait, you did because you said it.
I didn't know that. I didn't know that day that he was hanging around people like that.
I didn't know
he was hanging around people like that. I knew he was drinking.
You did.
That he didn't want to help himself.
He's changing the story right now.
I knew it days ago, but I figured he'd snap out of it. And this morning, I brought him breakfast this morning. I cared enough to bring him fucking breakfast and coffee to help him.
You thought you were
going to help out. Help him
$200
out.
A month.
He thought he was getting $200 in.
To start trying. To stop drinking and start trying again.
And he's going to get free labor on the teardown house. He's like,
yeah,
man, here's...
I'll bring him McDonald's breakfast.
Yeah, Burger King probably. Let's.
That's true.
Burger King fucking sausage croissant, whatever the hell they're fucking called.
Yeah, it just blew me away that he doesn't want to help himself. As much as I want to help him, I can't help him because he doesn't want to help himself. And I can't take the chance of him coming here and hiding beer.
You mind up to this woman calls you a stalker after you have been accused of it before.
This whole argument here is pointless because, again, he was fine with her coming over there. So he can't sit here and bitch about, you're not going to protect me, I'm going to get in trouble, when you're setting yourself up for that to begin with. So, like, you had no problems with it. Hours before this. Ramona's bartender's diaper donated, I think. He's so self-righteous about Roy's alcohol problem, yet the only reason he's not drinking is because of fears of prison more than he loves beer. Yeah, they put the fear of God in him when...
Right. He's even said before that he wishes he can have a six-pack.
Oh, yeah. He wants to go and buy a rack of... Bud Light and Hammer.
He thinks just because he's not allowed to have alcohol, or because he'll go to jail if he has it, means he's like cured of alcoholism.
Yeah, like he beat alcohol all on his lonesome, not went to prison
it's
and
like,
detox.
No. If I took away all of his cigarettes from him, then that doesn't mean he quit smoking. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Yeah, it's just, he's so stupid. When I got out, I wanted to rebel. Shins donated and said, did Roy ask to let him and his friend move in, or did Lauren offer?
That's a good question.
That is a good question, Shins. I don't think there's a definitive answer to that.
I think... I'm trying to think of how Lauren explained it. Or, like, the scenario was, like... Because why was Lauren going over there in the first place?
I would assume he was trying to get Roy to help him do work. So he
and
was trying
he
to figure out...
And saw the hooker and Roy and was like, you both want to live here?
Yes.
I bet he asked, honestly.
I would think Lauren probably pitched too. It sounds dumb, and it's very one-sided, so it sounds like a Lauren gimmick. So I would assume Lauren just offered, thinking he's getting $400 in his pocket a month for ciggies. That's my guess, my best guess. I don't know if Roy's been to prison, to be honest with you.
He's been to jail, though.
He has been to jail. Jill Pill once again donated and said, it's possible that Roy called Hookah and said, you know my brother's an RSO, so she showed up knowing she wasn't going to stay there. Also explains why she suspected he's been stalking her. Possible. I mean, I know, from what I've heard, Roy is very loose-lipped about Lauren's charge. But...
That was funny, back when I didn't think Prep Rat was that big of a weirdo.
Yeah.
She went to go visit, and Roy was walking around downtown, just drunk, yelling, my brother's a pedophile, my brother's a pedophile, just yelling it.
Yeah, that's hilarious. I would think that the hookah went with intentions to live there. and realized she was going to a kill shack and was like, I'm fucking out.
Yeah, she's been in those scenarios before because she's a hooker. So, you know, she has a sixth sense about these type of things, I bet.
Yeah. Yeah, I also heard Roy was in Walmart one time and did that.
Oh, yeah, he was wandering Walmart and he was like, my brother likes to touch children. Or he was yelling something else.
Something
he was
like that. My brother's a piece of shit, he's bad out.
Yeah.
Daddy Roy.
Yeah, you know? My brother likes little girls or something like that. I'll have to look through the text that I have with her again to find out exactly what.
Yeah, I think I have one of those too.
But what he said, but it was something like that.
Something
he was
like
just
that.
Walking around wherever the fuck, downtown. Scowhagen.
Yeah, Roy doesn't give a shit. Well, I mean, remember
because he's also, you know, 15 beers deep. He doesn't realize what's going on.
Well, it's like that voicemail that he played for either Jamie or Casey where he's like, I know what you did, you fucking pedophile.
Yeah. Oh, that's a good one.
That's good. Roy knows. Roy knows. Thank you, Shins and Ramona's diaper and Jill Pill. Thank you.
Who gives a fuck about this woman? I'm not talking about this woman. You hung up on this woman.
Cause that's
I don't give a fuck about her. I don't owe her shit.
Yeah, it's the whole linchpin.
I don't owe her shit. I offered her a plea. Jamie, will you stop, please?
You just were dummy.
I offered her a place to stay.
That is Rhoda.
She didn't want it? Fine. Whatever. She pissed me off with what she fucking said.
So what? Are you talking about her again?
It's cause you did.
But you weren't taking about her. Right.
No, you're good.
Why are you going round and round on that?
Yushi.
I don't care about her. She doesn't want to stay here. That's her. I don't care.
Oh, he doesn't care.
I was just trying to help out and offer a place for him to stay. Mm. It's just like Roy. Trying to help him out if I can offer him a place to stay. It's the only option he has other than a homeless shelter.
My boy can go fuck himself now that she's out of the picture.
Why would you say that? I've been trying to get Roy to stay here all week.
That's what you just said, dumbass.
Right. Oh my god.
I've been trying to get him to stop drinking all week, and you know that.
No, yeah. All week.
But I'm not going to have him bringing people around here like that.
Hey, why isn't this alcoholic stop drinking? It's been one whole week.
You are literally complaining about me saying help Roy. Good God.
I have tried to help Roy. I've been trying to help Roy. Why are you telling me to...
Why are you telling me to... Donation from Element Circa?
Element Circa 15.
Love y'all. Love the show. I love y'all. You make me get through my work day. If Re and Blue... Duet, I need you. I will double this donation.
I need you.
You! That's as good as
we
get.
As close as we're going to get. Duet in this
thank
thing.
You, Element. Appreciate it.
My breath, like.
I always feel like he's saying, I need you like Macy's. I don't know why.
Well, you know me. I don't like the singing, so the second I hear him do it, I have to pause it. It's been a while since I've heard it.
I'll be just rocking out this fucking garbage. Yeah, that's for sure. All right, so Jamie hung up on him again. I believe...
The Roy Box Killer.
The Roy Box Killer. Duke Cohen, thank you, Lawrence Moms, Camel Town. Okay, all right. There's not many hang-ups now, but he stays on the phone longer.
Hello.
Fuck off.
Whatever.
Ooh, is he throwing shit?
I think he's playing
like
in the dishes.
Me fuck off or...
Oh, yeah.
He likes to do that.
He gets mad and just starts, like, scrubbing dishes as hard as he can.
I think he likes to play in the dirty sink water. Seriously. I think he just likes to shuffle around in there, like, with a rubber duck or something.
Yeah, that's a screen name for you. Lauren's dirty sink water. Dish water. Fuck off.
Because you are ridiculous.
No, you're ridiculous telling me to fuck off and hanging up all the time.
No, you are.
And you're
what is he doing?
And you're ridiculous for thinking that I'm going to have Roy over here when he keeps bringing alcohol over so he can get my ass in trouble. Then I'll find out
he's
hanging around bullshit like that and you think it's because of her.
I'll let him finish his thought. Hold on.
Because of her insulting me. embarrassing me or whatever.
Husband,
you said.
When you hang up all the time and it's fine.
He is unwrapping dishes out of paper that he bought at either an auction or a sale. That's what he's doing right now.
Damn, you're good.
Because you can hear him, like, what is it, like, right about here?
Then I'll find all these hanging around bullshit like that, and you think it's because of her. Because of her insulting
That's
me,
yeah.
embarrassing me, or whatever.
And
you
then
said,
you
then.
Hang up all the time, and it's fine.
Then he'll clink. He'll clink again, but yeah, he's unwrapping garbage he bought from somebody else that he's going to sell at a yard sale.
ADD, he buys these things because he buys lots. So
yeah.
he'll buy just a pallet of random shit. And this just comes with it.
Yeah, like he'll... Or he'll go somewhere and he'll buy something. Sherlock Reborn. There was a guy up the street that was doing a yard sale. And he's like, hey, how much is that refrigerator? And the guy's like, $300 or some, you know, some bullshit. But I'll give you all of this shit on top of it as well. And he'll be like, give me all of it.
Yeah.
For like an extra, he'll give like, pay $500 and he'll get a fridge worth $100. And then these dishes.
Commemorative TMNT China sets? I would actually like that a lot.
I mean, hey, I would actually jump on that if it was possible, but I wouldn't buy the whole lot, just the dishes.
He does that a lot with, he bought used tires off the side of the road for $150, bald
yes.
tires.
And he said he was going to sell them for like 80 a piece.
Yeah,
because
he's
shit.
Like, oh, this branded tire is such and such, and he was going to just finesse this dude. And then he took him to a used tire shop, and they were like, we can't take these.
Yeah, like, we're good.
They were, like, completely bald.
They were bald, and he was like, oh, I'm gonna get... And then they just sat in his yard for ages.
They're probably still there.
Probably, with his fucking windows.
They were probably holding up the tarp.
Yeah! The fucking tarp, man. So stupid.
So the problem is, Jamie, is that you want me to look after Roy. You want me to look after Roy. You look after me with the internet people, but you don't look after me with my own brother.
Holy fuck.
You want me to look after him.
Holy fuck.
When he's tried to help him so many fucking times, to see him this morning was just... I told him. He looked disgusting.
You were the one who was fucking inviting him to live with you, idiot.
I told him he looks disgusting.
I mean, who would you rather kiss on the mouth? Roy or Lorne?
Oh, man. It's...
Give me Roy all day.
Yeah, definitely, you know.
I mean...
Okay, call back real quick to the stuff he's unwrapping. I'm pretty sure, I could be wrong, but the trailer tour where he goes, Jamie, does this look familiar? And he's showing the cups and plates. I think it's that.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yeah. But yeah, I mean, I think Roy's going to win this hands down. I'd kiss Sadie first.
No, that's not an option. It's either Roy or Lorne.
Skittish.
You can't cheat. That's not the
well,
game is Roy or Lorne.
Someone, Jill went a little far.
What?
It.
Oh, God.
A little far, Jill. But you don't have to go that far with it.
Well, it's nice to know where someone...
You know, hey,
yeah.
The extent you'll go with
yeah.
it is all that matters.
Yeah, I was. But he doesn't care. He doesn't care about himself. I can't have him here if he's not going to care about himself.
So how is that on me, stupid?
Is he, like, throwing them into the sink?
Because you're telling me to fuck off, and you keep trying to tell me that I need to help him.
Oh, thanks, George Glass, my boy.
George Glass.
Can you imagine if the greatest thing you ever did in your life was got caught on To Catch a Predator? That'd probably be the worst life you could ever have.
Right, but that's, like, the pinnacle of Lorne's existence.
Well, not in his mind. I mean, everyone else's mind, yes, that is the pinnacle. But in his mind, it's either playing basketball in middle school or...
It's just funny, to like the moment right before Chris walks out, and it's like... From that moment on, it's just been a downhill, just...
just nothing's worked. I mean, like, he obviously talked about Amanda James, but from that point on, like, nothing
yeah, but like,
was
that
real.
Was, I mean,
yeah.
Sure, he was catfished a handful of times by Amanda James and whoever that we don't know about, but...
Back-to-back prison.
The second Chris walks out, it's like, it's all over.
Yeah.
It's never been Ray ever since.
No, a bunch of girlfriends never show up. Goes back to Joe. You're right, though. Yeah. That is, it ruined his fucking life.
I can't help him when he doesn't want to help himself.
But he didn't know that.
I'm not supposed to be biased being part owner of this company here, but I'm really pulling for Maria in this one.
she's
and by taking the chance of him coming here and bringing people like
I
that
think she's
here
a fan favorite, so.
And alcohol here.
If only
you're gonna put me
really
in jail,
like,
and I'm not gonna let it happen.
I don't think she looks anything like that, but
if you want to think that that's me thinking about myself, then yeah, that's me thinking about myself. I'm not gonna let him fuck up my life just because he's fucked up his own.
Good lord, love how kicking your brother to the curb because you don't like this woman is my fault.
For real.
I didn't say it was your fault. But you keep putting me down. You keep finding fault with me for wanting to fucking help people out.
Wonder why I'm saying fuck off.
I do like this line from Ramon's Diaper. Maria cheated 9 times in her match.
Well, you keep putting me down, Jamie.
Oh, baby boy.
Why would you put me down for trying to help somebody out?
That's not what she's putting you down about.
Right.
You aren't.
No, I'm not now.
So he wants credit for helping someone out even though he didn't help somebody out.
Yes.
Because
that's exactly
because he tried with a hooker.
Yeah.
He can find his own way. He did it to himself. I didn't do it to him.
So why should you be praised?
Would Lauren have been in jail in August 2011? I'm looking at the trailer and then from then and it looks green. And not like a place I'd get killed in.
When did he get out of prison? 2012?
I'm not sure, to be honest with you. I don't know when the first, like... When was the first... I don't know. Ember didn't talk to him when he first got out.
Yeah, 2012.
Okay, thank you. Yeah, I should probably know that, but... Yeah, so, yeah, it would be before he got out. And then he got his hands on it. Because he was living in a different trailer when he first got out. When he was on YouTube and stuff, that wasn't the trailer he was living in. That was the one he's living in now. He had one before that, I think. And he got kicked out of it. Or, not kicked out. He moved into his dead uncle's trailer after a while. Yeah, he moved... There you go. Moved in 2017.
Where was he at? Whose trailer was that?
That was... it's not Uncle Clay. I know there's people that get confused. It's not Uncle Clay's trailer. It was Uncle... Oh, man, what the hell was his name? Uncle Earl? Uncle Earl just died. Something like that, maybe. Uncle Rich, maybe.
Uncle
okay.
Rich.
Rich, all right.
That sounds familiar.
Yeah, all right, guys. All right. All right, Uncle Richard.
Richard?
Ron. Ron, Richard. I know there's an Uncle Earl or something like that. Uncle Cracker. Hell yeah. Alright, well, anyways. He got it from that dead uncle. He was in another trailer when he was filming on YouTube at one point. The end of that story, I guess. Uncle Cooter. Uncle Richie.
You don't have to praise me, I don't care.
You sound like you care.
Yeah, you asked more.
You just want to keep putting me down, so just go with that.
Just go with it.
You seem to get a kick out of it.
I mean, I don't know for sure if he was kicked out. I guess I should rephrase that, but I would assume he wasn't paying his bills because Ramona says, you owe your uncle for rent, da 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 da. If do you know what would happen if I didn't pay rent? I would be kicked out. Something like that. So, I mean, I'm guessing Uncle Beetlebug.
If you don't care, you wouldn't be saying half this shot.
I'm taking my mailbox.
Well, I do care. But there's nothing I can do about it. Nothing I can do about you putting me down. Nothing I can do about Roy fucking not wanting to stop drinking.
My God.
Nothing I can do about where he put himself. But there is something that I can do about him coming here and getting my ass in trouble.
Then why did you offer him a place
just,
to live?
It annoys me so much how he thinks he's so much better than Roy.
Oh, I know.
It drives me fucking crazy.
My favorite's when he lists off things that Roy does when he's drunk and acts like he's so better than him, but
yeah.
He did the exact same shit.
Yeah, and worse shit.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, he gets drunk and just blames everything on his past.
Like, Roy can kill a whole family in a DUI. At least he didn't try to fuck a kid.
Yeah. Someone points out, Billy points out that the one time Lorne lived on his own was a natural and ended up getting caught in this thing.
Yeah.
Lorne should not be left to his own devices, I guess.
I love you, so my focus is on me and you.
Oh.
Not me and you, unless...
Roy was drinking in a row, but you were going to move him in today. Then decide you will get in trouble, but in reality it's because of this woman and you won't own it.
It's because of this woman, because Roy's bringing these people like that around him. And you're not understanding that.
And again, all this lady did...
All this woman did...
was say, I don't want to live in this shit.
I don't want to live in your fucking kill shack.
Yeah. She didn't do anything wrong.
No. All she said was no, and then Lauren got mad when she was, like, looking at all the other options, because she was going to hand him money that day.
When she called him out on following her around town?
Yeah, then he was mad. What a bitch. He destroys everything he touches. That's true. He's like a Midas, except not gold. It's shit.
And you're not understanding that. I'm not going to have people like that around here.
But you were going to.
No, I did, dummy.
You and your name calling, don't know.
You and your name calling. She saw he was she saw it was shit and he was being a creep? Absolutely.
I'm not gonna have him getting me in trouble.
My God.
Stop with this whole shit about getting in trouble.
Yeah.
I'm not gonna stop with this whole shit about getting in trouble, because he brings alcohol around, it gets me in trouble.
That power bomb.
He brings people like that around that will fucking cause problems.
You clearly didn't care yesterday.
That'll get me in trouble.
I'm the one getting abused.
What?
You clearly didn't care yesterday or today.
I tried to get him to come over here yesterday.
But now you do.
Every day I've tried.
But now you do.
Yeah, because I see what he's bringing around and I see that he's not going to stop.
So is the problem the people he's hanging around with, or the alcohol?
Apparently it's the people he's hanging around with.
It just switches in this conversation a lot.
Yeah. So if he wasn't hanging out with the hooker, his drinking wouldn't be a problem?
I think.
It's very confusing. It's just, it's so obvious what it is, and the, you know, the robot keeps telling him, I know what the reason is, just own it. And he's like, oh, I'm gonna.
Right, the woman.
Yeah, that's part of the reason, because of the fucking woman. Because he's bringing people like that around him. Because he's bringing people like that around.
Just admit it.
Jesus Christ, Jamie.
Jesus Christ.
When he's bringing people around that act like that, I don't want him around.
To tap dance around ITB.
Don't worry about it.
No, I'm not tap dancing around anything. Did she insult me? Yes, she did. Oh, well. There's nothing I can do about that. I can be pissed off about it all I want. Doesn't matter. But I can do something about her ever being here again.
I cracked open a Celsius.
The alcohol only gets you in trouble if you drink it. Is that the issue?
No.
You will drink or have?
No. No. I can't have it on the property.
Are you sure about that?
So what's Roy do? And we stopped at Walmart. Mom even said it. He's probably buying alcohol. I didn't see him have any alcohol when he came out with bags.
Right, when did this happen?
This is last weekend. He put the bags in the back of the truck. He got in the truck, and I asked him, I said, you didn't have any alcohol in there, did you? And he didn't answer me right off.
But you were moving him in today.
Trying to get him to stop drinking. He acted like he was going to stop drinking when I called him in the morning. And every morning he's acting like that.
So why does that story matter?
Because he brings alcohol here.
Yeah, Dr. Pepper's getting...
But you were moving him in today.
He goes and puts it on the neighbor's land. Then he goes over and drinks it.
Today.
What is your point, Jamie?
What's your point?
I'm trying to help him out and trying to get him to stop drinking, trying to get him to get his life back.
Are you?
Get his
life back.
Because
he's got no other option other than homeless shelter.
Roy is living the best life. Like, Roy loves his life. Probably. Maybe.
He's drunk and still gets laid.
Yeah. Like, he's drunk and having sex. He doesn't worry about anything.
Yeah. What life does Roy have? Let's think about it. Okay, so he had an ex-wife that divorced him because she was a bitch or whatever, according to everyone that knows her.
Yeah, okay.
Then he had an ex-wife that left him for his stepdad.
Which is a good reason to become an alcoholic, if you ask me.
I wouldn't know how to cope, I'll be honest with you. I mean, what life? He doesn't own a home.
Right. I think Roy's just accepted his fate at this point. Like, Roy's just like, I'm gonna get drunk and live at the park until you find me dead in a ditch.
I'm just gonna drink till it ends, man.
And have sex with these prostitutes.
Right. Please get your life back. This is my dream come true. Roy's just drunk on the bench.
I didn't want to see him go there.
You were moving him in today and you are listing shit that happened days ago.
Yeah, I'm about to see him this morning, too.
What's your point?
My point is he doesn't want to help himself. He's hanging around, starting to hang around people that don't care about themselves.
Right, the woman.
Yeah, the woman. I tried to help her, but that wasn't good enough for her, so whatever.
She doesn't care about herself, how?
Well, she doesn't care about herself, by wanting to have a place to stay where she can get up and walk around. She'd rather sleep in her truck. That's her problem, not mine.
Walk around?
She doesn't have a place where she can get up. She can get out of her car.
She can get out of her truck and the whole world. She can walk around anywhere she wants.
She could walk in Walmart. She could go walk around in a parking lot.
How much room does she have to walk around in a shed?
The dumbest fucking thing I've ever heard.
Yeah, is she like a pony? Why does she need room to roam?
Listen, if she doesn't use those legs soon, she's never going to use them again.
You mean like atrophy or whatever?
I can still fucking stay.
Her job is walking on like the corners all day long.
She stands on the streets all day. She wants to hang her head in a car. Give her a fucking break, man. Count to be donated. Said Roy's nice enough to put it on the neighbor's land. Exactly. How are you going to get in trouble when it's on the neighbor's land?
Yeah, why does he care what she does?
Exactly. Why would you care? Because he does care. He cares really hard.
She doesn't want room to walk around.
You can top that off.
I offered. She didn't want it. Oh, well. I wasn't going to have her bullshit to tell me that.
Goodbye.
That she's seen my truck following her a couple of days ago.
Shipping container in winter.
We're going to insulate it.
Well, what a bitch.
I had already told her that we were going to insulate it. I was already insulated from when Roy was in there.
It was partially insulated because of Roy before.
And she was all game for that.
Yeah, until she saw it.
Yeah, why? Oh my god.
Yeah, I'm sure you didn't sell it as a metal box in your yard.
Comment at the end is the issue, clearly.
Her comment at the end is a major issue.
That's the issue.
That's a major issue for me.
Why?
Because I'm not going to have people tell me that I was following them around a few days
because
ago.
You stole
and I've never.
Before.
Jamie, knock your bullshit off. What you're fucking doing sounds really fucked up.
It's in the paperwork.
What is she doing? Oh, baby boy.
I had. What?
What?
Yeah, what got fucked up there or something?
You had what?
What?
You said I hang up all the time, but you'd be Jamie Canto, so I figured I'll call you back, because...
So he hung up and called
Jamie,
back instantly?
No, fuck off.
You're trying to find fault with me again, all over again.
The paperwork he's talking about...
Something that happened fucking years ago.
Wrong window. The paperwork he's talking about is the... He got stuff... He gave it to Jamie when she had a voice, and it included court documents, The thing that said he was 87 out of 87. It also talked about the Nikki stalking and, you know, like, his drinking issues. Just shit like that.
Something happened fucking years ago that, you know,
you
I was trying to help somebody
to
out then.
What?
What decision?
It just sucks. It's every time he tries to help someone out, he gets a restraining order or goes to prison.
That's crazy.
It sucks.
He must be really bad at this. I'm new to the Mormon verse. Is it is it all this about him controlling Roy, or jealousy that Roy is, has alcohol and women? I think it's jealousy a little bit, yeah.
It's jealousy, and Lorne, for some reason, just thinks he's a better human being.
Yeah, he thinks he's better than Roy.
And he likes to feel that. He likes that there's someone worse than him, in his mind.
Yeah. Now, here's the thing is, Lorne always has a scheme cooking to get easy money. So this instance is just that he was going to get $400 a month, but he needed the woman there. And Roy doesn't give a shit. So if the woman moved in, he'd get some money.
Mm-hmm.
So now that he's not getting any money, it's fuck Roy again, because Roy's a piece of shit. I mean, that's pretty much how I see this.
We mean what? I don't even know what you're saying what to now.
Repeat what you said.
I say you bring up this thing about this fucking stalking years ago that I weren't even stalking her. I was trying to help her out and trying to get fucking money back.
He acts like Jamie's never seen the paperwork.
Right, she's seen the paperwork and the police report on top of it.
Yeah, there's police report.
It's not like a, oh, I was just helping her out. No, you... Oh, yeah, sorry. You know what? Dan Jones is right. Unintentional
stalking. That's unintentional stalking. That's a good example.
He weren't stalker. Oh, my goodness.
And she called the fucking cops on me.
That's not what the paperwork says.
Or whatever it says. That's the way I remember it.
Well, you are unreliable.
I try to forget stupid shit like that.
It says you pulled her a
shit. You should remember those things and learn from them.
You should grow from those experiences, yeah. You fuck.
That's why they keep repeating themselves, because he forgets about it and then does it again.
That'll never happen again. Oh.
Yeah. Trying to get a hold of her because she owed me money.
You hide her name on your phone as my man.
Yeah? What's your point, Jamie?
Yeah?
What's the point? Why is her name not just Nikki?
Yeah. Yeah, fuck. Why do you choose Mom?
That's a great question. I think let's just hear the follow-up, because I think that he's...
Does he
say... Why?
Why are we going back up there?
Why?
Mom and... Mom Nikki.
Yeah, dumbass, we were able to piece that together.
Listen to his brain shut down.
Mom and... Mom Nikki.
Mom Nikki. Hold on. I think he might.
I don't know why. I don't remember why I did it.
Oh.
I do that.
I'm not going. Yeah. I'm not letting my fucking self go way back there right now.
I put people's names in my phone with just funny things, and I'm like, who's this? I don't remember why I did that.
Everyone on my phone is Mom and their first initial.
Gets confusing when there's like six Mom N's. Donation from a generic white female. Hey, Blue Boy. Hey, Reborn. Just donating to tell you I wasn't donating. You guys are the best. Thanks for the entertainment.
Thank you, Prashish.
Thank you for the warning donation. I appreciate it. Thank you very much. I don't remember why I did it. So there you guys go. He explains Mom N, sort of. Mom N. Hold on. One more time with that. Where's that shit at?
Mom N. Mom Nikki.
Mom Nikki. Yeah, but why is her name Mom Nikki?
What was the reason you gave for calling her 100 times?
That's a good question.
No, no, Jamie. What's your point in all this fucking thing?
Oh my God, Roy killed him.
Because this fucking woman says that she saw my truck following her.
No, we're talking.
She didn't
see
my truck following her. I've never even seen her before.
The cop just showed up doesn't add up.
What you got, Lauren?
Jimmy, I don't even remember it anymore.
Convenient.
Why do I need to bring that back in my memory?
Donation from Salty Baby. Working hard or hardly working, boy? can't. Apologize to Blue Boy for me for interrupting the stream. So sorry. Peace. Thank you, Salty Baby.
Apology not accepted.
Oh,
just
no.
Kidding.
Oh, no. Why aren't you protecting us and the stream, Salty Baby? Why do you keep taking Roy's side?
Clearly it's still there if this woman's comment upset you so much.
Yeah, because I'm on fucking probation. I'm not going to have people like that around me.
Right.
We're back to this. And a cigarette.
What do you mean, right? You don't think that should matter?
People calling you a stalker.
Yeah.
I'm happy
every
day.
Clearly it's still there if this woman's comment upset you so much.
It pisses me off. Call me a fucking stalker. I've never even fucking seen her before.
But you did!
Did the shed have a pee bucket?
Probably, actually. There's a trees. You can shit out there. Tyrone Donane said, "Hey guys, I just stopped by.
Oh no,
just put my beer in the refrigerator for the rest of the call. Thank you, Tyrone.
Thank you.
Your beer's in the refrigerator. Also, guys, we're in the darkest timeline.
Thanks for stopping by.
We're in the darkest timeline now in 87 wrestling.
Oh no,
I'm gonna have people like that around me.
No,
Lorne beat Roy in a false count anywhere. I know.
This is like Jinder Mahal.
This is Jinder Mahal reign for sure. This is like a." Just heat, dude. This is someone's got to stop them.
I put my pee bucket in the shower in case I miss when I'm too drunk.
Who pees in a bucket?
I don't know.
Lorne is unfortunately the new champion, guys. He beat his brother. I'm so sorry. And I had no control over this. This is what fate decided. Lorinder Mahal.
Oh, God.
Oh, man. And unfortunately, that's the end of the wrestling footage for tonight.
The reign of terror.
I didn't get enough produced before the show.
Oh,
we're just going to leave it on that shot for the rest of the night.
You're constantly finding fault with me. But trying to find fault with me.
I'm trying to find fault.
Likewise.
What's up with that?
Likewise.
Likewise? Like what, Jamie?
Trying to pause it with him holding the belt up.
Oh, that's a horrible.
I don't want to find fault with you. I just want to love you. But you keep fucking doing shit to fucking to make me wonder, you know, what the
Who
fuck?
Who did you call, Jamie? Who was on the phone, Jamie? How much time are you giving them, Jamie?
Yeah, well, what's with all the attention to fucking Carter? All the attention to Carter?
Yeah, well.
I hated Carter.
Carter
when you call
great.
Your fiance bro yeah, while well. You're trying to have fucking phone sex with him.
Yeah, well.
Clark knows. Clark, thank you so much.
Gotta have the heel to build and slowly build the next hobby. Exactly.
That's right. You know, Will's making a name for himself on the circuit. Jim Roush needs a rematch. He was screwed out of the belt, so.
Mm-hmm.
Next, this is a pay-per-view. This is not in your trailer house, if you guys didn't know. Next pay-per-view, we'll have a triple threat match for the world title. Also, Pee-wee Donian said, "You two are my only sexual stimulation I need." Thanks, Pee-wee. That's kind of weird, but I appreciate it.
You're very sweet.
Jim never got his rematch. Roy's number one contender. Triple threat.
What's up with that shit?
Yeah, well.
Well?
Yeah, well.
Well, do you answer my questions?
I don't know.
Why? How did...
Shut the fuck up.
He's trying to flip it on her.
But I was going to say, we go from him being a stalker to now he has to bitch about Carter.
You keep saying shut the fuck up just so
I
you don't have to answer my question.
Stupid.
No, you did not.
Oh, coffee
yes,
time.
I did.
Alright, then what's up with calling me bro when we're having phone sex?
She called him bro during phone sex?
No.
I actually remember that, if I can find it. Lauren's about to get going. He's in the bathroom ready to, you know,
come. Or in the kitchen.
Might have been the kid. I think it was the bathroom, though. And he's like, "What are you wearing?" And she goes, "Booty shorts, bro."
Booty shorts, bro.
And I believe his words were his dick inflated.
But did he say, like,
deflated? Sorry.
But he was like, "God damn it." He, like, did that again, right?
Yeah, like, oh, Jesus.
But, like, remember when, with Ramona, when he's like, "Why can't you say anything good about me?"
Yeah.
He did it with, like, that inflection of, like, yeah. Oh my god!
I just want to cool! Nass.
This shit's fucking. Jesus Christ, why don't you see
you
this?
You are such a child.
No, I know. I'm a child because I don't want my fiance calling me bro. Getting worse from some guy that she seems to be giving an
shut
awful
up,
lot of
bro.
Attention to.
Shut up,
baby.
Yeah. Oh my god.
Why are you trying to find fault with me, Lorne?
I don't want to find fault with you.
Oh, okay.
Why are you trying to find faults with me, Lorne?
I'm not trying to. I want to know when you,
you
do shit
me, Lorne.
Well, Jamie, when you do shit like that, how do you think
you
that makes me feel?
Me, Lorne.
How do you think that makes me feel when you do shit like that? Call some guy to fucking see what time he's coming over so you can dress nice. It doesn't even sound right.
So she was having company over and wanted to look nice, and that's a problem.
Yeah, apparently looking nice for company is a problem. You should look like a bum when guys are showing up, Jamie.
I'm not wearing anything sexy.
I don't want to find fault with you. I just don't want you doing that shit. It's like, why would you do it? Why would you even care?
Literally one call.
Right,
why
Lord,
did you care?
I can have excuses for doing it, but when I point out my reasoning, it isn't valid.
For doing what, Jamie? What am I doing?
Yeah, he knew fault for like one call, because it goes to false. He's asked to spell it. It's false. You know. What's worse during, John Fishman donated, what's worse than during phone sex, calling bro or calling Dan? Probably Dan.
I would say calling Dan would be worse.
But I do think that bro was a good second place.
Yeah, yeah, calling Dan's worse, I'm gonna say.
Yeah, oh, definitely, definitely. Hi, Dan.
But he's having phone sex with a male robot. That doesn't do anything. Like, that didn't...
Right. There, I think there was one time where Jamie, because he was, like, getting pissy, and he was like, you gotta say something. And so the robot's just like, oh, yeah, I'm gonna kick your balls in. Oh, that's hot. And he was like, oh,
yeah. Oh, yeah.
Every other time it'd be like a bowl of mac and cheese being stirred. You'd just get all excited. She sounded like a fucking walking through a marsh.
Ding.
Like a clink of
the spoon.
And William Fetters, Xavier's not booking. The robot, a robot is actually booking for us. So. Mm-hmm. Dan was definitely Lauren's kryptonite. Yeah, I would agree. I think that Will became a good nemesis for him. His, Superman to his Lex Luthor,
yeah,
or some
Will
shit.
Will was like
Joker
a frenemy.
Joker was Batman. Yeah, frenemy, yeah.
Trying to help somebody out?
You were an asshole to them.
Salty Baby, I do know the sound you're talking about. He would ask Jamie all the time what she was wearing and how her hair was, and she'd always say side ponytail, and he would, like, comb his pants.
I hated
time.
That fucking game. I'm wearing a hoodie, Lauren. What's underneath?
What's underneath every fucking time? I just want to get a picture. What's your? How's your
hair?
I know.
Hair? I think Casey. I was like, just picture me whatever the fuck you want. Who cares?
Love Donate said, I fucked them all, Lauren, and that is true. I mean, with
I
the exception
them
of
all.
I wish there was a time machine for Will to go and fuck them all.
That'd have been great.
Did Will have to make mac and cheese? Every time. No, there was this sweet video called ASMR mac and cheese stirring that Jamie would use every fucking time. And it just so happened that Jamie forgot that the spoon hit every time and would have to pull
Lord
it
never
away.
Heard it. Didn't we also at one point just play like the sound of like a sink running and he thought she was in the bath and he was like jerking off, but this bathtub just never filled up because it went on for like 2 hours.
Yeah, it was like... I think that was like ASMR running water,
yeah,
or something, and this tub you would think
this
was
tub,
the size of a room.
Yeah, it just never filled up.
It just kept
going, and Lauren just like sitting there listening to it.
Just like touching it, trying to get going.
But that one's weird because it's like there was no, like, she wasn't making sexy sounds or anything. It was just the thought in his head of her in a bathtub.
Well, that was enough.
That was enough.
There was one time Jamie sent a photo of just her toes in a bathtub. Do you remember that? Blue toenails.
No.
And he sent a dick pic immediately. He was full of blood.
From looking at her toes?
Yes, dude. She's,
I mean,
he's into feet, he's into piss.
If you're into feet and piss, I mean, have at it.
He wanted to pee on Jamie. This is getting weird, guys, alright? Thank you, Love, for the donation. Let's see what happens next.
Well, she was being an asshole to me.
Well.
Of course I'm going to get offended if she's being an asshole to me when I'm just trying to help her out.
So Tammy got up to 4.5 inches.
Is he into pee or is he just like into anything deviant because it's like closeness with her? Because he was obsessed for a while about things that like neither of them have experienced.
That's true. The only thing is he brought up pee with Ramona.
Oh, okay. That's... And, like, changing her diaper, right?
Yeah. Okay. And he even said one time she would have sex with, like, he would take the diaper off her or something. Yeah. And he got all embarrassed when that came out.
But he likes gross things like that because it's, like, intimate things that you right. wouldn't normally share with someone.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, like...
Like, he's turned on by her pooping in the shower and stuff because it's, like... No one else gets to hear about you pooping in the shower.
I heard it thud, baby.
Oh, God.
I think that, so this thing, he used to do this with Jamie a lot, and it was like he wanted, like you stated, just something they have only done together.
Yeah,
and
like,
no one else. So,
because he can't take her virginity, so.
So it's like anything that, have you ever done this before? Yes,
yeah.
Damn it. Move to the next thing. Have you ever done this? No.
Yeah.
Well, it's going to be our first times too, baby.
I'm more creeped out, yeah. But Lila Daisy says the hair thing creeps me the fuck out.
Yeah, he is way into hair. He gets mad. It happened with Ramona and Jamie. They both said they were going to cut their hair or shave their head, and he got pissed. Like,
yeah, she's going to shave the side of her head, right?
Yeah, because it was sexy and badass, and he said, who gives a shit about being sexy and badass?
But yeah, it's anything that... The girls haven't done, like, car sex, right? He was obsessed.
Yeah.
He's like, we'll just go outside and have sex in the car, even though you can just go in the house, but...
He wanted to have sex with her pretty much everywhere, and when asked, like, because you're an adult, why don't we just do it in the bed, like,
just to say comfortable. We've done it.
Just to say we've done it. The other big one was having sex in the closet that he was making, because that would have been the first time anyone had ever done... I mean,
yeah, she
honest.
Hasn't had sex in a closet before, so
right.
She needs to have sex in the closet.
Yes. Even though I think if his uncle never had sex in that trailer, none of the trailer would have had sex in it before. So he could have cracked... He could have broke it all in.
Oh, yeah, the dog shed. We'll have our boots on so we don't step in dog shit.
God, I forgot about that.
Don't pick up the dog shit.
No. Just
put
wear
your boots on.
Listen, we'll just go out there naked with boots.
Man,
on.
Imagine driving down the street and you just look over at Lynn's property and he's just banging some chick.
They both have boots on.
Over the doghouse. Did you see the doghouse when we were there?
I didn't see it.
I don't think I got a good look at it.
There's a giant tarp in the way.
Well, I got beyond the tarp a little bit.
Beyond the mat. Yeah. Yeah, you did.
And I was just hit with like a bunch of dust and pollen in the face.
Probably ticks and
yeah.
shit. Alright, well, Lauren probably liked Tub Girl. Oh, God. Probably.
What's Tub Girl? Do I want to know?
Google it.
Do I want to Google it?
Probably
know.
Not. If you want to enjoy the food in your belly, yeah, probably not. Probably not.
And Roy, I want to help him so bad, but he doesn't want to help himself. I can't do anything about it.
Back to this, huh?
And I'm not going to get myself in trouble for him.
Pee-wee's donated and said, would you rather lose your phone or your wallet?
I have nothing in my wallet.
I guess wallet, even though I wouldn't have an ID, I could still pay for things with my phone.
Yeah, I just have cards in there. I can cancel all my cards with my phone. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Yeah. Interesting question. Thank you, Pee-wee.
God damn it. Now people are saying I gotta look up.
Don't look up. Well, go. Yeah, do it right now.
Okay,
I do it in, like, incognito so that it doesn't pop back up. When you type in, like, I need a tub.
The algorithm for my Google images is like... Wait, what am I looking up? I already forgot what it's called.
Tub girl? Yeah.
So I point that out and you cry like a little bitch saying I don't defend you and point out faults.
Well, I'm just seeing sexy.
You didn't defend me on that. You
asked
me saying why do I not want to help him out now? You're saying why do I not want to... You're repeating yourself again. I heard you the first time.
You aren't defending me, Lorne. Why are you trying
defending
to find
you.
Fault with me, Lorne?
Why are you calling some guy to fucking see what time
it.
He's coming over so you can look nice?
Oh, wait.
Go to fuck off.
No, it's not it.
See? You don't want to answer that.
I told you why that night you did shit.
Sorry, we're trying to look this up. Donation from?
Anna Rourke.
Thank you. I butcher his name every time. In a Blue Boy call, Lauren mentions the life insurance form that was criminally falsification just because a form was filled out. Any background on that? I think it's because he was receiving life insurance.
No, yeah, someone had filled out like a life insurance policy, and the paperwork was mailed to Lauren's trailer. Like, it was just someone messing with him. Like, you know, people mail him birthday cards all the time and stuff. I think it was something like that, and Lauren thought he had like a case against him, but I don't think it came to anything. Did they take Tub Girl off the internet? Because I'm not seeing
it. You can kind of see it right there. Kind of. I can't. If you click on it, you won't see it. It goes to cats now.
Okay.
Yeah, that's Tub Girl. It's gross. Okay. You answered the letter.
I don't know any other.
Yeah, I think that he said he was going to go after them legally because they were signing him up for things that that were in his name, and that's like, I guess as he put it, falsifications.
I don't know how he was going to go after whoever did that.
Because you couldn't tell who it was.
Yeah, I don't know. Yeah, like you said, no one the form wasn't submitted.
Right. Thank you for the dono. Appreciate it. Thank you. And now, everyone, don't look up Tub Girl, by the way. Don't do it.
You told me that you like to look nice for company. You told me that you like to look nice for company. That I can understand.
No.
When you're singling out one person.
Dude's dead.
That's disturbing. When you're singling out one person, it's disturbing.
When you sing that one person out, it's disturbing.
You clearly don't understand.
Oh, I understand that you want to look nice. That's understandable.
Look up Lemon
Party. I just don't like that you're singling out one person.
Okay, this is like probably just right before your time. These were all like the things you'd look up online. It was like gross.
Like, when was this a thing?
Like Two Girls, One Cup time. You know that one?
I've heard of that one.
Yeah, that's gross. Four Girls Finger Painting.
Don't know that.
It's pretty much the sequel to Two Girls, One Cup. It's gross. Lemon Party is up there. It's not as bad as the two I just mentioned, but I mean
what was that one? Finger painting? What?
Four Girls Finger Painting.
Is it, can I guess what it is?
Sure.
Are they like playing around in period blood?
No, actually, surprisingly.
Oh.
It deals with pretty, it's like Tub Girl kinda.
Okay.
It's a lot of like, I'm gonna get this fucking stream's gonna get knocked if I talk about it online. Two Girls, One Cat, yeah, I mean.
They're still making snap, good for them.
But yeah, Four Girls Finger Painting was pretty much the same thing. One Guy, One Jar was another one. One Guy, One Jar is getting a lot of, like, I see, like, memes of it popping up again. Do you know what that one is? Dude put a jar up his butt.
Oh.
And it breaks.
Okay.
Why
are people doing this to themselves?
I don't know. It was, like, shock value on the internet back then. It was just like, what the fuck is this? You know? One Guy, One Hammer is a little different. Yeah, I know, guys. I know. It's just there was a point in time in the internet where, like, this is what everyone talked about.
I know. Must have not been on internet
I
yet.
Mean, Pain Olympics is awful, Salty Baby. All right, let's stop talking about this. Let's move
stop.
On.
You have the answer, but you just said I don't answer the question, moron. Do you listen to yourself when you speak?
Yeah. Do you listen to me?
Yes.
It doesn't sound like you are.
How?
Because you say
answer,
you like looking.
You just said I don't answer the question more.
George Glass, don't say that. You like us all. I mean, you're my new boyfriend, right?
I'm with George Glass on this.
I'm telling you, man, like
you people are fucking weird.
There's
just
a good documentary on Mr. Hands, dude. Why's that guy have a documentary?
One Folgers Cup, is that one?
No, I think that's
someone
just
make it. Oh, I'm stupid.
I know all my degenerate shit. The internet was a mistake. I mean, yeah.
Yeah, I don't think we were made to be use the internet.
No. Zach, I'm sorry.
Because you say
answer,
you like looking.
You just said I don't answer the question, moron. Do you listen to yourself when you speak?
You like to look nice for company. Understandable. Why single out one guy and call him and ask him what time he's coming over?
Oh, have you seen that? What Nugget said? Have you seen that documentary?
Of the lady
he
that
just
was attracted
said I didn't
to the Eiffel
answer
Tower.
The question.
Hilarious.
Yeah, didn't she start cheating on the Eiffel Tower with a fence?
I saw one where this lady was like attracted to like a crossbow.
That's odd. Did you know the guy that was in love with his car?
Yeah.
Did you see the follow up?
No.
His car died.
It's
like something fell on it and they couldn't repair it.
Something fell on it?
Yeah, yeah. And now he has a new car, but his bedroom is just like his blanket has photos of his old car and him together on it, and like photos of him and his old car.
What the fuck?
And his new car doesn't get jealous.
Because it's a car. Do you not go to a doctor for this type of stuff?
I don't know. It's odd. It's odd shit. But yeah, the Eiffel Tower one, she said she was married to it, right?
Yeah, I don't know how you do that. But
I don't either, but apparently... But yeah, I remember seeing a clip of her, like, fondling a fence and, like, sitting on it and being like, this is getting sexual.
Hell yeah.
I agree, it is less pathetic than 87.
What?
Being married to the Eiffel Tower and fucking a fence is probably less pathetic than 87.
Yeah.
Ram Ranch is a classic. Wow, guys, we're getting really off subject here.
Yeah, we're gonna get roasted for this one on the temple.
This one's...
Why would you even care what time he's coming over
when you have a fiance? You just said I didn't answer the question.
Why do you care what time your company is coming over when you have a fiance?
Good point, Lauren.
NCA, I would agree.
That is insane, though. What? If you really think about what he just said.
Yeah. Yeah.
Like, sometimes that stuff just, like, brushes over me and I, like, forget about it.
Right.
But if you sit there for a second and you think about that sentence.
He's mad. And saying, why do you care what time your company is showing up?
That's fucking insane.
Yeah. Could you imagine, like, you have people coming over and you're like, well, I can't show up whenever you like because I can't let my fiance be jealous. Does the Eiffel Tower have a jealous boyfriend that yells at it? How come you didn't tell the Eiffel Tower that you had a boyfriend and that it's me?
But the Eiffel Tower has pictures of you on his wall.
You just go to the Eiffel Tower one day and there's just pictures of Lauren all over it.
Yeah, I said you did answer the question, but why would you single out one person? Why would you single out one person? And why would you care? Why would you care what he thinks? Why would you care what he thinks when you already have a fiancé? Honey, I don't want to find fault with you, but I can't not tell you what bothers me.
Lauren won the bell.
Fuck all five.
And I do it. What?
What? What?
I can't not tell you what bothers me, and I expect you to tell me what bothers you.
God forbid I have pride and like to look nice.
Well, that's fine, honey. I love that. But I don't love it that you called one guy just to see what time he's coming over.
That's just like a normal thing you do.
Looking nice.
Hey, what time are you coming over?
Hey, I know we agreed on 7, but are you still coming at 7? How dare you call him and ask that, you fucking bitch?
I'm not wearing anything sexy.
Someone comes over, you don't see me in a jock strap.
Yeah.
Or having pride? Or having pride, which one is that?
Both, I guess.
No, gee, thanks. So I suppose I should go to a construction job in a suit.
How is that the same thing?
What the fuck is he talking about? No, but you should go there, like, in a hard hat and a construction... What are those orange things called? I don't fucking know.
Like a vest?
Yeah.
What? Like, are you fucking... I like to look nice when I have company over. Good. Oh, yeah, well... I'm going to go to the construction site in a shoe.
You know what, Lauren, when you put it that way?
Oh, well, in that case, I'm going to tell him not to come over. The fuck is he talking about?
Wouldn't you rather have your girlfriend be dressed and ready for when the guy comes over versus her not?
So Lauren would prefer that Jamie doesn't dress up and be nice when the guy comes over and instead wears sweats with no bra.
I feel like he'd be mad about that too, though.
He would, exactly. Why weren't you wearing a bra? Well, you told me not to dress up.
Yeah, what construction job?
Yeah, it's a good point, Clementine. What construction job?
Wear fat people clothes.
Wear fat lady clothes. Yeah, it's all going in now. Wear fat lady clothes. I just can't... Hold on, I gotta hear this stupid D one more time.
Oh, Sigmund, I'm normally on AirPods, and I'm not on them today.
So I suppose I should go to a construction. Suppose I should go to a construction job in a suit.
It's not her job.
Yeah, I'm not understanding the correlation between the two things.
There isn't one. There isn't one. I mean, having company and going to your job are two separate things.
Yeah,
with two different dress codes.
This is one of those moments I want to just be in his head, just to see.
It lines up for him.
Because that made perfect sense to him.
Like, if he was on The Price is Right or something with that kind of thing, he would have won.
I sound like I have a lisp.
Oh, no. Oh, no.
I don't have a lisp. Do I?
No, you don't. Daisy's got a good point. Why are you so awful comfortable wearing sweats around that guy? That's exactly what it would be. Why are you not putting on normal clothes?
I don't know what
that
does to me, but...
Won't even live at your place.
That's not my problem. That's hers.
You're not with Wes too much.
I think it speaks more to you.
Got him. That fucking...
Roasted.
What are you?
Roasted.
Yeah.
So it speaks more to me because I offered her a place to stay. But she didn't want to stay in it. She'd rather stay in her truck instead of being able to stay in a place where she can move
because
around.
It's filthy.
Oh God, sorry, I'm malfunctioning over here. I can't. We went back from the clothes and just shot back to this.
She'd rather stay in her truck instead of being able to stay in a place where she can move
because
around.
It's filthy.
Stay she in a place move. Where she can move around? What?
Yeah, she's of the land, like a Native American. She can walk. She can go anywhere she wants.
She can literally open the door of her car,
and walk around.
And just, she can do laps around her
Why
home.
Can't she walk around?
I can't. Just, it's the dumbest fucking reason. He's a saint because he's giving her some place she can walk around.
Like a free range whore.
Free range whore. You're a dirty, dirty free range whore. That's the line of the day right there.
Yeah.
She didn't see the inside of the house.
Star for you today.
Yes.
Whoever said that.
Right. Does Ramona's die for what?
She saw the shit.
Then
she didn't come in the house. Wow.
Well.
Well.
Here I am trying to fix the house up so that you like it. I don't give a fuck if any other woman likes it.
Okay.
Line of the day.
Come see me, Swifty.
You'll have to keep working, I guess.
Well, why wouldn't I keep working?
Keep working? What job?
This argument, I'm completely lost.
Yeah, it's just bouncing to every... He's trying to get out of not looking like an asshole, so it's just pinging all over. You know.
Or was that a put down?
I feel like I always start off, like, at the beginning of the stream, I'm, like, coherent, I can follow along, and then we get towards the end, and my brain just turns off, like, just turns
that's,
to mush.
That's how he thinks, so. That's how he works, though. It's like, if you just keep talking in circles and changing the subject instead of answering, eventually you're just going to be like, I don't even know what we're talking about, and whatever, Lauren, you win. Why does he call it a shed when it's a shipping container? That is a great question. I do not know. Imagine if a cheap hooker said your place was disgusting. Another blow.
I know, I'd be pretty insulted by that.
Yeah. If she was living in her car and said, you know what, I don't want to stay here. It'd be pretty rough.
Then again, I have a much better house than Lauren's trailer house.
Right. That's a dagger to the... Chicken house, chicken shack, shed pen. That's exactly right.
She looked at the chicken house. She said, "What's that?" And I said, "It's a fucking chicken pen."
It's a chicken pen. It's a chicken shack.
I wasn't talking about a job. We know you don't have one.
You mean the house?
You mean
to make
house.
It look nice? No shit. I need to keep working on it. I already know that, but thanks for stating it.
Good one. Just skip the silence after Lauren's fucking zanger right there. His zanger went off, and there was 18 seconds of silence.
How's Costello
going? I love you,
going?
My How's the what?
How's Casella going?
I haven't heard from him.
The what?
I don't know. I don't know what that one was. Hold on.
How's Casella going?
Seller?
How's Casella?
How's Casella going?
I haven't heard from him.
I'm assuming this
Casella?
Is a job.
Casella?
I'm assuming this is a job he applied to, or was at a job fair or something, and thought he had the job.
Okay, I'm gonna Google that word.
Donation from Modigro. I don't.
Yeah. Modigro's.
Thank you. Is this the same woman who looked at them shed, said no, then asked if the chicken house was suitable? Yes, this is the same woman. It's the. It's just a carryover from last week. They
so,
still argued about it.
Casella is a waste systems company?
Yeah, okay, that sounds about right. Thank you, Mo, for donation. Thank you. Yeah, so this is what Lauren would do. He was getting pushed hard and hard to get a job, so he would go to a place and go there and be like, can I get a job? And they're like, yeah, put an application in. And then he would put an application in, and they would tell him, like, you know, a usual interview goes, like, I'm going to apply. What do I get? Here's your pay. Here's your benefits. And then he thought he was hired.
Sometimes it didn't even get that far. He would be like, well, they told me to put an application, so that means they're hiring, and I got the job now.
Remember when he said he applied to a job by going up to a man and saying, can I work with you? And he said no.
Yes.
Fucking kid. Oh, fuck, wrong window. Yep, just like Nestle.
So I guess I'm going to have start up the business and work for this lady through the winter. And whatever other jobs I can get from the business, I just got to figure out how I'm going to go about doing it without internet people knowing that it's mine.
You can't.
You can't. It's impossible.
I'm wondering about post office boxes.
The way you do that is don't be a pedophile. But unfortunately, a time machine doesn't exist yet.
What you do is you don't drive to Bowling Green and get caught in a stand.
Yeah.
Oh, wow, shit.
Sorry, bud, but that's just your life now. This is...
Yeah, out of luck.
If I
just
use
want different
post office box, that'll
Listen, just
be enough.
Don't put me on the register.
Do need a physical address or not?
God, Evil McNugget says here's like a cat.
What do you mean? Who's got that jingle bells? My cat does.
So I gotta call H&R Block and ask, see if they know the answer to the question.
He's going to H&R Block to ask about a P.O. box with his address on it. Why are you going to H&R Block and bugging them with that shit?
They don't have those there, do they? No?
No, they do.
That's just like
taxes. They do taxes.
I've never been inside one.
Yeah. So he's worried about his job having his address on it, so he's gonna go to H&R Block to ask about P.O. boxes and if his address will be attached to that.
But they'll still know the name of the business. Why does that matter? So people can't send the company mail? But they'll still have a phone number and everything. Sorry, Lauren, you just can't get away from this.
It's just like his pallet business. Like, everybody found out about that the second he got it on his fucking
2 seconds.
Yeah. Everyone was passing that shit around.
He's my head is so wound up about not knowing what to do
dumb.
About a vehicle, and said really don't want a payment button.
Oh, she's playing with a toy right now. It's not even a caller. She's collarless. She's a free.
I might not have a choice in the matter.
Joey donated and said H&R Block, like someone who has a week of income tax training, would know how to get him off the RSO.
Yeah, I don't know if he knows what H&R Block does, because I don't think you can go in there and ask him these questions.
You just slam down some papers. I need a new job.
Fix this for me.
Yeah.
It says I'm a pedophile.
Listen, how do I get this pedophile thing off of my name, please? I bet my cat could kick your cat's ass down.
I don't
want to
dump a pile of money into.
Thank you, Joey.
I'm going to drown your cat in a brook.
Into this truck because it's got 253,000 miles on it.
His truck has 253,000 miles on it? Can you rewind that? Sorry, I keep talking over it.
No, you're good. Yeah, that truck's old as fuck. You got it for like $800.
I don't want to dump a pile of money
into
this truck because it's got 253,000 miles on it.
So this is not the truck he had the loan out for then, because remember he had truck payments when Casey was talking to him.
Yeah, this is a different truck. So when he first got out of jail the second time, so let me rephrase that because that doesn't sound right. When he got out of jail the second time, he had a tax truck, because he said the first time. Would it be more fair to say, he had a tax return for the work he did before he went to prison, right?
Yeah.
With the tax return, I think he got $1,000 out of the tax return. He spent $800 of it on this truck he's talking about now. And was like, it was a hell of a deal. And then he had to keep working on it, and it never got past the test.
Okay, I remember this truck now. That reminds me of the... this is the one he got pulled over for by the cop, right?
Yep. And okay. This is the one that he was using the welder on without a mask on.
Yeah.
That's
fucking
that truck.
Idiot.
Yeah. Hannah was not Kelp Pill.
No.
That's why I wanted to talk to you yesterday about whether or not I should get one.
Why did he get it?
Because he didn't have a vehicle. I believe that the van he had didn't work anymore. It was used for storage for dog food and chicken feed at some point.
That's where I keep my dog food and chicken feed.
In a van that's just broken down on your property.
But
the Dodge Journey got repoed, I think.
Yeah, because he went to prison.
Yeah, and he couldn't make those large payments.
I mean, is $800 for a truck that has 250,000 miles on it a sweet deal?
No.
It doesn't pass inspection.
It doesn't. And he went back, I think, 3 or 4 times to get it passed to pass inspection.
I remember that.
And he couldn't each time. He had to make new panels for it. My cats will remain anonymous. Okay, guys.
They don't like to talk.
They don't like talking. Let's go. It looked like there was a Silverado in the video when you guys drove. It did, actually. I don't know what. That might be his new truck that he was doing payments on.
That might have been it.
Put the cat on mic. It's Silent Cat, all right? That's what we're going to... It's Silent Cat, okay? Silent Keep. All right. That truck from the yard sale is probably the one he was making payments on. The other one is that if you see in the yard sale footage, the I Need You music video where his head's poking out of that truck, that's the $800 truck. I'll play it to close out tonight, but that truck that I use in videos is the truck that he got for $800. All right? Joey, I hate that he's the champ too. Trust me, I was very upset when this happened. All we can hope is that his reign is very short. There should be pay-per-views every 2 weeks now. We got it set. There's 12 a year now. So.
When does it update to the new?
After this pay-per-view.
Oh, okay.
So we reformatted the whole shows. You'll see them when they
new logos and everything.
For anyone that's an 87 wrestling fan. New logos, new arenas, and yada yada.
Because you're not an adult and can't make a decision for yourself.
Holy fuck. Because I tried to include my fiance in on the decision. Why try to find fault with that?
Why?
Why not? Because you're my fiance.
I can't drive.
But no kidding. But you know, you might want to have a choice in what vehicle that I get.
Why? I can't drive.
Well, I know, but...
Why would she care?
How do I know what vehicles you like?
She doesn't... She just said she doesn't care.
What one you would like or what
I
one you wouldn't
drive.
Like?
Hold on. Let this part play right here.
I was just trying to include you, honey. I didn't want to leave you out.
Not NXT 2.0. It's much better. I mean, it looks like someone put money into the company, finally. Okay, so Lauren wants to know what Jamie's favorite cars are because...
Probably something expensive.
Yeah, because he's going to drive that car, even though Jamie doesn't drive. He wants to know what kind of cars she likes, even though she at 25 years old.
Is that attractive to you females in the chat? If you know, if a man can't make decisions for himself.
Yeah, is that hot or what?
Do you like that? Do you like it? You pick out what kind of car I have.
You pick out my minimal payments, yeah. Baby. Why can't she drive? She just doesn't. She chooses not to.
And I think that was an excuse for her not to go to Maine.
Yeah, someone would have to take her.
Yeah, Warren never. I don't think it even got to the point where Warren even asked why she can't drive, right?
Or I don't think. I think he asked like why, and she just goes, "I never had to."
Oh yeah.
She'd get limos or a driver to take her to shoots and stuff, and then the driver became Will. Very weird.
But like a man who can't make decisions for himself.
There's nothing more attractive than a guy that asked me if he should buy the pepperoni or the salami.
What's your favorite, baby?
Yeah. What do you think I should do?
Like, he can't even pick out the Christmas tree ornaments by himself.
Yeah, he can't do anything by himself. Sorry, Joey donated and said hot shot the belt onto Rod.
Can't do that. The computer has to decide, and it's the way it's fair.
Yeah, that way fate decides the answers, and there's divisions, so Rod is actually not fighting for the world title, unfortunately, right now, so. But yeah, he just sucks. He can't make a decision for himself.
But he thinks that's, like, flattering or, like, cute.
Like, I kind of get the general idea of what he's going for is, like, he wants to include her into big decisions because that's what a couple would do.
Right. And I think that'd be different if, first of all, if Jamie cared about anything.
Right.
If she cared about the thing.
Yeah.
And they're not face-to-face. Mm-hmm. So.
They haven't broken up yet, just based on timeline. But she's not there. There's no way she's going to be there. Null, the date on this call is 9/24/20. For those of you that don't use American time or North American times, it is September 24th because there isn't a 24 month.
Yeah, I always get that confused. Because we do it the opposite where I'm from.
Oh, see, yeah, there you go. And where I'm from, the year's at the front. The trailer sold. What?
The trailer didn't sell.
Anyways, would love to hear Rod drop an MJF style promo. That would be good. We're gonna try and for the 87 wrestling fans, not so don't all leave. There's still more of this call, just a little bit left. We want to try and make like actual episodes of this too, so there should be promos and stuff, and maybe I don't know. We'll see.
I love. I just look up his address and I just love that RNS Palace is listing 1 star, 18 reviews. People write the funniest shit on here.
I'm sure, like, people look up his business and go, 1 fucking star? No way, dude. Alright, let's get back to this.
I'm sorry for finding fault with you.
Oh, I'm sorry, Dan Jones. Oh, yeah, Farmer, they're holding hands. I've heard that rumor, too.
I don't give a shit. You will again.
I really think he close to perfect.
That's a fucking lie.
If you change everything about you, you'd be perfect.
You're pretty much next to perfect, except for what you wear, what you do for a living, your friends, your hobbies, and you're not up here, where you live.
No, you don't.
I just thought it's important for me to tell you what bothers me.
It's not, though.
What bothers me?
Everything bothers you.
That's true.
No, everything doesn't bother me.
Yes, it does.
He did get insecure about the robot tight. He,
yeah.
He didn't believe it. Remember, because when he told her,
yeah,
you tell the story.
No, you're good. There's some, like, brainwashing going on, so, like, whatever Winnie/Emma said to him was gospel, even though, like, the person telling him is like, no, this is the truth. It'd be like, no, Winnie and Emma told me you were this tall.
Yeah.
It's like, no, I'm 6 foot. And then Will would come on the phone, she's 6 foot, Lauren. Yeah, but Winnie told me one time that she was 5'6".
Great, okay. Still taller than you.
Cool, well, I'm telling you that I'm 6 foot tall.
Yeah.
Yeah, sure, yeah.
But then he acknowledges that Winnie and Emma would lie to him all the time.
Yeah, but it's crazy.
He picks and chooses what he wants to believe of what they told him.
Be like a day before, he'll go, those two have lied to me and done so much fucked up shit to me. You don't understand, that's why I'm the way I am. And then the next day he'd be like, there's people making hundreds of thousands of dollars on YouTube off of my name.
Yeah.
Who told you that? Emma? Okay. Didn't you just say they're liars? What? Fucking moron. Xavier came by my house when I was in prison. Who told you that? Elmo? Okay. So you believe those things, but if it was you, they were your friend, that's the lie? I don't get it. Whatever. Put her on God level.
I'll try harder.
Exactly, ADD.
Apparently I was lying about my cousin getting in a car wreck.
I don't remember this story.
I was being open with you and letting you know what was going through my mind at the time. You wanted to know my thoughts. I've never done that with anybody else.
You do with everyone.
Oh, thank you, William. I'm glad you like Casey. I heard she talks like a monotone idiot, and she's not funny or original.
Let's play Casey Call.
Oh.
Right open as in, you didn't believe what I say.
No, I believed you.
No, you didn't.
Yeah, I did.
No, you didn't.
It's just important for me to let you know what was going through my thoughts at the time.
I mean, Winnie is the best catfish. I've never argued it.
Oh, yeah. I mean, she got Lauren Peak, you know, drunk and shit. I've always said the robot's the worst.
No, Casey's the worst. You can admit it. I admit it, too. Casey is the worst, because at that point, he's been beaten to death, and I do have a monotone voice, which can get boring, I guess, to some.
You know.
Winnie's the best. Winnie's the goat.
I think Casey's gimmick, whole gimmick was being disinterested, which...
That's what the idea was, but some people didn't get it. Like, the idea was to ruin... Lauren had this idea of Casey in his head that she was a certain way. And then I wanted to destroy that by her being a fucking bitch the entire time. And I don't know if you've heard of the call yet. When Casey, there's a part where he, how did it go? He was asking her about like past relationships, and she said she used to date, who's that pedophile? I forget their names.
Oh, she was dating, Bald Beaver? No. Gosh, you're pretty. I think it was that guy.
Was it Bald Beaver? Bald Beaver Hunter? Is that
maybe.
She called him Johnny. Is that who
it was? Something like that. Yeah.
But anyways, because he was like, "Oh, you must think I'm real special to want to talk," or like something like that. And she's like, "No, I dated
John
Elliott, I used to date John Elliott," and Lorne got so pissed because he like wasn't special. He thought he was like special to her. like for some reason he's the one pedophile that you know is different. And I was like, I used to... Johnny and I dated for 2 years.
Yeah. Son of a bitch.
Yeah, he was like, I can't picture you doing that. He was all butthurt about it.
I still don't understand why you do that, but you would understand it if it was me.
Yeah.
Or like Lauren, you know?
I think it goes, for me, Winnie's number one. Then Ramona. I like Ramona's calls because it's like, before Lauren was suspicious of being recorded at all, so it's like the purest form of Lauren.
It's pure Lauren.
And then I would say Jamie. And then Casey. Are we missing a catfish? That's all of them, right?
Debbie?
Oh.
Debbie didn't date him, though.
Yeah, I don't know I never consider her a catfish.
Yeah, I was kind of... I guess Debbie would...
Well, in that case, I think Debbie would be my second favorite because I like the... You don't... The cocksuckers call.
Yeah, go...
That's my favorite call of all time.
Fuck your fucking cocksuckers.
Who's Casey 2?
Casey 2 is when Winnie was Casey. Casey 1 is Casey Moreau.
Casey Moreau's not a catfish.
No, but it was the first Casey in his life, I believe. Casey 2 is Casey, which was Winnie before Winnie.
Oof, man, this is a mindfuck.
And then Casey 3 is you.
Okay.
So Casey 1 is just Casey Moreau, but she's not technically... She's just the first Casey in his life.
Oh, Tiffany, I remember Casey 2. I liked that one. I don't. What was wrong with that one?
Probably like way too. I would say
like
it was sexual.
Like, yeah. I mean, if you're.
Pee-wee hates me. Good.
I could see why people don't like the sex talk stuff, but to me, that never bothered me, so I thought it was funny.
Yeah, it just depends.
It's humiliating.
It's humiliating, like, for
that's,
sure.
That's
yeah, me. Like, I get the aspect that... I see the understanding of... the ununderstanding. I see why people can get mad at it.
Yeah.
But I think that you're forgetting that, like, hundreds of people are listening to him coom on the phone to a robot or something, and it's like, that's humiliating.
Yeah.
Or having Dan pop in and be like,
yeah,
hello!
Yeah, it was always funny. Or just, like, just the moaning of the ghosts.
Yeah, yeah, like... That, the, like, that's the mac and cheese, like, that's, I think it's great. I don't have a tier list, but I do, and then I know it's blasphemy to some, but I find that the Ramona stuff is great. I mean, that's how I started my channel, was doing lies from the Ramona saga, if you will.
Mm-hmm.
I find it interesting, as you said, it's more pure Lorne. I think that Winnie got the best of Lorne, for sure.
She's just the funniest one.
Right. I do think that it's more... Whereas we're like the robot in Case 3 and the robot and Ramona, it's more of Lorne calls. I think that with Winnie, it's more of their Winnie calls. And Lorne's just kind of there. You know what I mean? Like,
I don't know. She gets some good stuff.
Oh, yeah. No, yeah. Definitely. I'm not saying it's not. You know. Well, Sigmund, thank you for that. But I feel like it's... Lorne living in Winnie's world, whereas it's like the other ones are living in Lorne's world. Does that make sense? Like, he's just reacting to a woman getting in a car crash with a mouse in her mouth.
Yeah, I don't know. To me, that's,
a dead mouse is in her
mouth. That's funny.
No, definitely. I'm not taking anything away. I think Winnie is, you know, for laughs, Winnie is, yeah, by far, yeah.
Yeah, if you want to laugh, you put on Winnie stuff.
Yeah.
If Rhoda's you want to hear him be crazy, like, I put on that "Go fuck your cocksuckers" call.
Yeah, exactly. But yeah, I think Winnie's probably the top tier. I mean, I don't want to make a tier list, but it's definitely at the top. Yeah, we should do that for a stream.
Yeah, we could.
I mean, I don't think anyone was bad. I wouldn't say any of them were bad. They all got good stuff.
I just think some of them had... I think you and I probably got as far... Like, the worst calls, probably.
Yeah, I mean, it's... When he came out sober, it was like, okay,
yeah,
well,
that's,
this
well, that's what I mean.
Good
sober,
luck.
Sober Lorne is fucking hard as hell to deal with.
You got to think there's Sheffrey, Rod. Like, there
I'm
are
saying
some.
There's like definitely quality stuff. I'm just saying, as far as the. There's
on
more listenable ones, I think, with Winnie and
Oh, definitely. Rona. Definitely.
But
yeah.
There's. Jamie has a lot of bangers, though.
Jamie's got some bangers, yeah, but there's a
like
lot
the
of.
The four Jamie calls that are really, really good are, like, really good. Compared
yeah,
to
I,
Ramona
I
stuff, where, like, Ramona is kind of all...
Ramona, there's not any, like...
There's not any really good ones, but there's not any bad ones.
I would say. I mean, one of my favorite Ramona calls, and I probably get crucified for this, but one of my favorite is Texas Girl call, and, like, Lauren's not screaming or anything. He's just...
No,
well,
I love
he
that
is,
call.
But he's just mad about her talking to her friend in Texas, and I don't know why, but I used to listen to that thing all the time. It was so good.
I'd be at work listening to that one. I listened to a lot. The Debbie call that I keep talking about.
Thank you, Zach. I appreciate it.
I think it's different when you're a part of it, too. This is why, like, Jamie and Casey stuff, I kind of just get...
Yeah, me too. It's just like, as Zach said, I'm my own worst critic. I always just shit on my stuff because that's how I feel. But I remember saying, like, on one stream, I was like, oh, this call's probably not any good. And it was one of the Yancey
calls. You
would
calls. Do that every call.
Yeah.
You'd be like, sorry, guys, that one sucked. I'm like, that was good, man.
Yeah, I'm like, man, that was terrible. Sorry. Oh, see, I'm glad people like Texas Girl Call. Hell yeah. All right.
We'll do a tier list later on, but we have a call to listen to.
We got about 4 minutes left of this call. Sorry, guys. We got sidetracked. But I enjoyed the conversation. I do see a lot of Hannah's and Justine's listed in the tier list. So. Okay, fine.
Because you're always wanting to get into my head.
That wouldn't have crossed your mind. That's the point.
You're always wanting to get into my head, so I let you in.
That wouldn't
I've never
have
let anybody
mind,
in.
That's the point.
He's quoting.
I've never
Ray
let
Wyatt.
Anybody in my thoughts before like that.
I was only listening to you because my daddy,
maybe
my mean old daddy.
Keep repeating it doesn't mean shit. It still stands. You didn't believe me. Maybe that should tell you something.
Why couldn't you just answer me when I asked you?
I'll say this, guys, real quick, and then we'll get back to this last bit of this call. But I understand that I haven't been on top of it as far as releasing this stuff. But twofold: one, I have my own life to deal with. But also, I don't know when there'll be more calls. So
how dare you, sir?
I know, right? How dare I have a life? But I'm just saying, like, at least I can bring you guys something at least every once in a while.
I mean, you know? I know people don't like the commentary sometimes, but I don't care about those people.
Well,
so they can just wait for it.
For those people, I'd like to say Heelborn has a video coming out this week. It's actually happening, guys. Heelborn made a fucking video.
Thank God.
Saggy Ass is finally coming out.
You piece of shit.
This week. Of all the calls I played, Saggy Ass is the one that made it to the edit room.
Cutting room floor.
So there you go. But yeah, you know, at least there's something to look forward to each week. I mean, like we were just saying though, I'd be like, yeah, this call, like I've played all the good ones, guys. There's nothing left, and then Yancey comes out, and you're like, oh, I forgot about that.
You forget a lot of. I mean, we still have to do Thruple stuff.
I've barely touched Recontact.
Yeah, I know. We still have a lot. There's still a lot of stuff.
Still shit. There's a lot. There's a lot left, guys. Yeah,
Heelborn Fee's not gonna die for at least the next few years.
Yeah, I mean, if I can at least put some time in.
I mean, at the pace you're going.
I know, what a douche. Let's all just give a big fuck you to Heelborn in the chat, guys. Just middle finger like, emotes.
Fuck, by the time we get this stuff, I'll be dead. Lorne won't be alive.
Thanks, Chris.
Anymore.
Yeah, right. We can listen to the finale on his grave.
Right, see how the truth comes out.
How the truth comes out? You go around answering my questions.
Sorry to interrupt real quick again. Dan Jones, what STD calls? I think I have almost all of them out except for Gami Bitch. And I know Fama reached out to me and said that I had played a call on a TLI stream, and I think I found it. I'm probably going to play that one next week if you're cool with that.
Yeah, man. I'm cool.
It's the one where she starts, 50 bucks is 50 bucks.
Oh, yeah.
So.
Yeah. Man, there's so much.
Yeah. Will the Mayor of Italy calls come out? Yeah, definitely. They'll come out eventually. Here's the thing is, I'm not going to lie, I just kind of wing it each week, and like I start going, like this call I just found quickly because I was like, I need something to play.
Yeah, this operation is pretty, you know. We're not pros over here.
No, we're just like, oh, fuck, I gotta find something to play.
Yeah, it's usually like, oh, we have to go live in 30 minutes?
Yeah, let me find something real quick. I mean, we can listen to the 50 bucks call next week and then a thruple call? If you want to do a thruple call?
I don't care. Dude, whatever you want. I like all of it.
Oh, yeah, of course. I mean, I'm not gonna bullshit.
It's all
gonna
get released eventually, so you don't care what order we go in.
Because you already assumed you knew.
Of German.
Man, sorry I'm paranoid, Moda.
Well.
Sorry I'm paranoid about it, but you seem to be giving him a lot of attention lately.
Oh, dear
God. Know why you are paranoid about ITV.
It's gold, Jerry. Okay, alright. Isaiah made a request for the cornhole call. I will try and find that in the next 2 weeks. Clobber might be covering for me for a couple weeks, by the way, guys, just to let you know. There's something to do with all ins and all outs, and I don't know.
Back to back, huh?
Yeah, I think all outs actually during the day, though, because it's England time.
Oh. Yeah.
Because you seem to be giving him a lot of attention lately.
Because you don't
once
trust
football
me.
Starts, we're going to have to do, like,
oh, no.
Saturday
Can
morning.
We just have, like, a...
Yeah, I'll have to...
Well, I trust
I'll
you.
Be taking many days
because
off.
You don't trust me.
I do trust you, but I'm not. But I'm bothered by it.
Count of three. I would do like a watch along stream. I just don't think anyone. I mean, other than you, maybe. I don't think anyone's gonna care to do a watch along for All Out.
Oh, watch along.
Is there a call where Jamie got injured because she was tired of? She tried to put a ventilator to her badge. Somehow, I don't think she got injured from that.
No.
Oh man, there's people saying they would. Pee Wee donated, said just one big fat thank you to you two. Oh, thank you.
You definitely don't want to watch wrestling with us. I mean, if you think we talk over each other now.
Wait till you hear us. Plowing over each other to make a shitty joke about some powerbomb I botched.
It disturbs me that you're giving them so much attention.
Your feelings, you coward.
Oh, of course.
Oh, no.
Not my feelings. My feelings shouldn't matter, right?
Yeah, that's what you just said, dumbass.
Yeah, why don't you open your ears, cocksucker?
What said on your feelings, stupid listener?
Portion of the sing the dance.
You just said, fuck my feelings.
I said on your feelings, stupid listen.
Yeah, you said on my feelings. Fuck off on my feelings.
Oh, fuck off. Own your feelings, you coward.
Ooh. Oh, own my feelings. Well, I did own my feelings. I told you.
He thought she said fuck off on your feelings? What does that even mean? He jerks off on them? Writes his feelings on a paper and cooms?
No, you didn't.
No, I did. You already know how I feel. I don't keep it a secret from you.
Lauren, what do you got?
Every time you say I do trust you, you aren't owning your feelings. Well,
Jamie, I do trust you. I do trust you. But I question whether you're thinking. I question whether you think about what you're actually doing. Yeah, I do. But I question whether or not you think about what you're actually. I question whether you think about what you're doing and saying.
So you don't trust her? Is that?
That's what it sounds like.
Oh, fuck off.
Of course.
It's 84. Yeah. Last week was 90 something. 91.
Let me be your robot and do and say what you want.
Uh-oh.
That's not what I'm saying.
Fuck off.
No.
When you give another guy so much attention like that, of course it's gonna
so
disturb
much.
Me. Yeah. Bro this, bro that. Bro even when they're having phone sex.
I think it was like the dare to before.
Oh, grow up, I'm done by.
Yeah, just play that one section
of
it.
Of course.
Alright guys, that was Metal Shed.
Yay!
We got through it. I know. I'm still on shit now. I know we paused a lot. I apologize to anyone who finds that irritating. And we went off topic a ton. But
if you don't like it,
you can leave! You know what, Napoleon? But yeah, so Lauren got slammed. Welcome to the jam. Thank you all for being here. Anyone who donated, thank you. We'll be back next week with... I'll put a poll up on Reborn. I'll give you guys three options. I'll give you the $50 call. What was the call Isaiah was asking about? The cornhole call, if I can fucking find it. And a thruple call, I guess. We'll do that.
There was something... Someone mentioned something else, didn't they?
There's the cornhole call. Fama wants to hear the $50 call. And I think thruple were the only suggestions.
Oh, okay.
But I'll put a poll up. You guys can vote. I'm going to put it up on the community tab, not here. Or actually, I guess we could just do it right now.
Yeah, just do it right now.
Engage your audience.
The people who are live with us should be the ones who get to decide.
You're right. What's next? Oh my goodness.
Amuro Ray with a... fat butt, you are very late. We're wrapping up.
With a big oily butt. $50. Amy, I don't have anything planned for this Lauren Miss. I'll be honest with you. I think I've blown all my good shit. What was the last cornhole?
Yeah.
Alright. We'll say it's those three. So you guys can vote now. We'll let this play out. You want to say anything before we go?
No, I don't.
Okay. Well, with that being said, let me get the music video ready. Make sure to check out Lauren's $800 truck at the start. I will close the poll at the end of this music video, and that will decide what we're listening to next week, y'all. And outside of that, this is why I stall so long. where the fuck did I put it? It's in it's over here. It's available. Champagne color. Alright, guys. See you next week. Stay safe. Thank you for spending your Sundays with us. And paper thin walls, goodbye!
'Kay. I don't know all the words of the song, honey, but I like the chorus. Again, oh yeah, you're the love that rescues me when the cold winds rain. And you're so amazing, that's just how you are. And I can't turn back now, 'cause you brought me too far. I need you like water, like breath, like wind. I need you like mercy from heaven's gate. There's a freedom in your arms, and it carries me through. I need you. Oh, I need you. Oh, I need you like water, like breath, like wind. I need you like mercy from heaven's gate. There's a freedom in your eyes. Here it is, no sunny. I need you. I need you, yeah. I need you. Oh. All right, my throat hurts. I love you. Bye.